Brother Weeber.
I love when they work in the name of the movie.
And oh, yeah.
Yeah. Like, it's when the Thunderdome.
They drew first blood.
Oh, I love
that's
it.
My favorite one.
I love it.
They drew. This isn't wait, the right song, from? But it will show them.
What song are you talking to, Jacob?
Oh, that's crazy. First Blood.
First the Blood, like the ending. End it's a long road.
I know. That's what we used to, me and, so Kurt Metzger used to me and Kurt Metzger used to do it. Just it's Frank Stallone singing. He goes, it's a
no,
long
it's not Frank
road. When you're sliced alone,
sitting alone,
you're but walking you're... in the neighborhood, and the cop doesn't want you there.
But mom, and then he starts bringing up his own personal shit. Mom loved you more, and that always upset me.
Took on the army and a local cop. He killed a guy who was in a helicopter.
Fell to a rocket death.
Whenever I'm depressed,
wild
I sing that.
Pig swam with the rats. Did everything and then
what were you
shot
say,
up
Jacob?
A gas station.
That's the song. I always sing those lyrics when I'm depressed. Make myself realize what a sad sack I'm being. I'll
first
just sing
blood.
Out loud. It's a long road when you're on your own. Dun, dun, dun.
Oh, dude, I love that. I love the thought that that's your fucking song to pump yourself out, get yourself out of a hole.
It's why I can't write lyrics.
Yeah, song lyrics.
It's the nightmare. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a long road. When you're on your own, when they drop first blood, that's just the
start of it. Yeah, you know what? Maybe 17-year-old me would beat the living shit out of me.
Jacob, 17-year-old you versus you now?
Oh, I could kick the shit out of 17-year-old me.
Really? You're confident.
In fact, you probably want to.
Yeah.
I have a lot of problems with that punk.
Yeah. So you think you could?
I know I could.
Yeah? Easy. Walk
Can
through
Can I
them?
Say before surgery? Cause they're,
yeah, oh, sure.
No, man. We're talking today. Time machine shows up
I
today.
I think I could take me.
There's no prefix to this. You got to fucking
do Jacob bullying. If there's ever reason to build a time machine to have Jacob bully
what's
a
up, you little fag? He goes, "Who are you? I'm you, but gray."
Fucking pussy.
Whoa, young Jacob coming after old Jacob. Jacob the gray.
I'm not gonna get mad at Big Pharma for making delicious OxyContin. He's right. It's the addicts. It's the people who are fucking sucking cock in the streets, dude.
Exactly. That's how I feel about cotton candy. Sorry, you fatsos, you gotta keep your hand off it, but I like it once in a blue moon at a carnival.
Yeah.
So why you gotta say it's bad if I eat cotton candy?
It is good stuff.
Fuck yeah, man. Me and Jacob tripped out together a couple times, man.
Oh, fucking, dude, me and him
went to the mountaintop together.
I don't want you guys fucking melting stuff down. Dude, if I gotta see fucking...
Jay. You know, the day destroys the night.
Remember,
night divides the day.
Yes.
Try to run.
I got a friend.
Try to hide. Break on through to the other side.
I heard if we go south on 75, I got a guy that can score us up with some Roxy, some Oxy, and a little Chica.
Just Jacob with the circles under his eyes.
Come on, man.
Who the fuck needs sleep, man? Sleep all I need. I'll get all the sleep I need when I'm dead, motherfuckers.
Jacob, do you know where the microphones in the studio went?
Oh, man. Goes, all right.
I don't know. Maybe they got melted down into some sweet...
Why, do you think I fucking saw them or something? Yeah. Fucking, why is it always me?
What is the...
Strung out Jake would be great.
I told you, I had... I went on a date, a terrible date on Oxy, and it was like the best time. I didn't care.
Oh, my dude, cool Jacob on Oxy.
It was like, oh...
What's your name?
Normally, I would have been bummed.
Newsflash, I don't give a shit.
He goes, check just got here. So we fucking or what?
Yeah. Here's the deal. You
all right, then Dutch it is.
Are you putting up or are we shutting up? What's going on?
I got a couple other bitches I can call early enough if you let me know now.
I got enough fentanyl to ride down I-81 and get sucked off at a motel wherever I feel like pulling off.
Chased our pleasures there.
Yeah.
Dug our treasure.
Charmed,
there.
I'm sure.
Still recall, time to cry. Bring on through to the other side.
Yeah, Jacob, was there ever a serious pull from you? Like when you did it? Because you've done it a couple times. Was there a moment where you're like, oh, I can't go back now. This is purely.
I had a few parties for one.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Jacob, when you come home, you want to come over and get nice one night, watch some TV? Yeah, dog.
Dude, don't make me do a PSA where I'm like, we have to do a Jay and Jacob-less bonfire rap about fentanyl being bad. Don't do it. It'll hurt your friends.
What'd you say, Jacob?
I genuinely enjoyed it.
What do you want to watch, dude? What do you want to come over and watch?
Nothing. You guys are wasting your lives away.
Let's get under a fucking throw blanket together. Let's get under a cakey coat together and just ride it out. We're having a party, man.
And then I got to talk to some fucking cop in a bulletproof vest with a flashlight on you when I'm over here. And he goes, yeah, we found him like this.
We had the glassy eyes.
Yeah. We think they were doing gay stuff.
Jacob, I don't want to do gay stuff with you, but if it feels nice, I'd rub your leg. I'd rub the inside of your thigh.
He goes, we caught him in scalp massage. We're pretty familiar with this. It's about three steps away from them sucking each other off.
Yeah. Luckily, they died before it got too gay.
We call it the snake eating itself.
Ride the snake. Jacob, you come over one day. We'll send Christine out. Me and you will get fucking nice.
When we last left you, Jacob, fresh off a very daunting experience of falsely accusing Liquid Todd of being Right Said Fred.
Yeah, Jacob got to meet Liquid Todd in the worst way possible.
Liquid Todd? By the way, you see he laid down a nice little tweet?
Yeah, that's your producer.
That's fucking, that's Radio War. You didn't see his tweet?
Yeah.
He goes, wait a second. Because I guess someone told him what happened. And he goes, so that guy.
The nervous guy.
So that nervous guy in the hallway was your quote-unquote producer? Yikes. And now we got a beef with fucking Liquid Todd.
I mean, come on, man. Jacob's a good dude. You don't know him like that. He was nervous.
I was.
Because you know what? You'd be nervous if you thought you were meeting Right Said Fred.
Liquid Todd.
And this is coming from
a huge
fan.
If you thought you were meeting Right Said Fred, you'd be shaking. I think he composed himself pretty well.
It's like meeting a president.
Which was so fantastic.
I realized as soon as he turned around, I was not dealing with Right Said Fred.
That's the best.
But the thing that had shot out of my mouth before I even could say anything was, my hosts are really big fans of yours. And then it was too late.
It's too late. And also, you were doing this dressed like you were going to junior prom. Today, you're dressed like the ghost of the guy who drag raced my father and spun out and died in 1957.
Yeah, he's got
he's back to haunt me.
Dead older uncle. This was my brother, Julio. He died before you were born.
We used to sing doo-wop on the stoop.
Hey, look at him. Yeah, he is. Just got a white tee and some jeans.
Fucking fantastic.
Oh, we're shutting the door. I forgot our door's open.
We gave him a fantastic story to walk over to what was...
A blind date.
A blind date that he hadn't been on anything, he said, in 15 years?
I hadn't been on a blind date in a long time.
Yeah, long, long time.
Who was in office the last time you went on a blind date? Was it George W.? Or was it Clinton?
Clinton, yeah.
Wow.
Last year.
Backstreet Boys concert.
Yeah.
But we brought you over here because now it's time to... Talking about Jacob.
Talking about getting sweet, sweet pussy.
I'm about to let you all down.
Talking about Jacob. Getting that sweet, sweet pussy. Talking about Jacob.
We can harmonize. What happened, dude?
By the way, that's going to be a lot of people are going to be singing that in their head when they get out of the car.
You're welcome for that.
It's going to be like the chicken parm. I love you so much.
Yeah. Fuck you, Peyton Manning. We got our own jam.
Talking about Jacob.
Talking about
sweet, sweet pussy. Talking about Jacob.
Jacob,
you went over there. You left here. Now, I will say.
Gasp up.
I got high hopes.
Yeah.
However, Jacob texted me about an email we got. Not very late.
Yeah.
So if he's looking at emails, I'm like, maybe she was wiping the jizz off her chest.
Well, I mean, I don't know.
In the bathroom, he probably hosed her down maybe, and she's toweling off, and he had a few seconds to check emails.
He's just, again, smoking another cool.
Babe, make me some eggs. I'm going to fucking smoke a cool in your bed.
I got to get to the business. The boys are getting fan mail.
Which I was very excited about.
That's not a good sign, Jacob.
So you left here. Shirt tucked in. Great story in the chamber.
Otis Redding in the ears.
Otis Redding rain in your head.
I opened with it. I opened with the story.
No shit. That's
Liquid
good.
Todd. It was
How'd
good.
It go? Did you tell it well?
I think I told it pretty well, yeah.
Did she seem into it?
Yeah, she liked it.
She laughed a lot?
She laughed.
She didn't laugh a lot. So we were worrying about her sense of humor. That's a fucking hilarious story.
Yeah, it's a great story.
I thought it was good.
What did she follow it with? What she does for a living?
So I have my period.
Yeah. Did get into that. She did bring up ISIS.
Oh, fun.
Oh, shit.
It didn't last long.
She's like,
it was good.
Why'd she bring up ISIS? She's
I don't know. We just started getting into world
politics. Oh,
I didn't bring it up.
Going to world politics?
I did not bring it up.
She
it was
jumped
fine.
Into ISIS?
We were talking about family living overseas, and then it kind of went
she's
into
she's like,
that
you ever thought about joining ISIS? If you're willing to go talk to a man who you think is right said Fred, are you willing to fight for the Islamic State?
That dress is va-va-va-voom. Really? Do you think it's va-va-va-voom if I was living in Serbia?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
So the date goes to ISIS. Is this where it starts winding down?
I we veered off ISIS towards the end and got into scuba diving talk.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah.
You both scuba dive.
Yeah.
You both have a passion for it?
Yeah, well, I...
Would you guys talk
she
tanks?
Went once. I have a passion for
was it tank
it.
Talk? A lot of hose and tank talk?
Gear? You just fucking riffing on gear?
Yeah.
I like to dive with a nice Polaris 75. You can jump back.
You know, you can eat stingray.
I've had it. It's very delicious.
It's chewy. It's a little gamey.
Did you guys maybe kick around an idea for a scuba trip together? Did you throw that out there?
That would be crazy if I just threw that out on date. Let's go on a scuba diving trip.
What was the closing fucking argument? Did you try to get to go longer?
I like that that's how you said it. What was the closing argument?
What do you mean you got to leave? No, I didn't say that. I mean, it was a good time.
Oh, she said I have to leave?
No, it was an hour and a half, I think, we were both about to say.
Did she say I have to leave?
She didn't say it like that. She said,
how'd she say
it? You know, we should probably get going.
I should probably get going?
Did she say we should probably get going? Did she say this was fun?
No, she said we.
Did she say this was fun? We should do this again. What was kind of the vibe? Yeah.
I don't know what that means.
That was Roadrunner. She was taking the fuck off. She was
Thank you, Dad.
Thank you, Lou. You got it, Lou.
I got to go, and then she fucking kicked off of Jacob.
To fight ISIS!
I think, like, that's a good time anyway, so no matter what.
You cut it at 90, no matter how well it's going?
I think you go past that on a first. I mean...
Then what? Say it.
No, I just think that's a good, as far as the blind date, that's a good opening date.
But what if it's going extremely well? Then you just continue it.
Was it good?
Yeah,
it was
good, but that was...
Was she hot?
She was a cute girl.
Cute girl.
Okay.
A few years younger. That's cool. She didn't mind that.
Did you tell her about the 65 push-ups?
Nah, that didn't come up.
Have you felt any feelings of jealousy that, you know, that Lou, DJ Lou's come out to see us several times at our gigs at... respectively Caroline's or the Cellar or stuff like that, and he's going to go watch his real love Sebastian Menkis-Kalkos this weekend at the Garden backstage?
No, I'm just a regular guy.
He didn't get you backstage?
Get through life.
Shut your mouth. He didn't give you backstage?
No. Oh,
Jacob, did you also just assume it was backstage?
I just assumed.
Yeah, so did I.
Who never gets on a list with his
Isolate that audio because you can hear.
I've never heard someone laugh so hard.
It's such nefarious. It's such evil. Like
no, but my mom went to see Sebastian in L.A. at the what was the Greek Theater, I said, Lou, could you get because I know he does meet and greets. I said, can you get my mom to go backstage for a meet and greet? It's her birthday. He said, dude, done deal. He had no power. He couldn't get it. He tried. I mean, I give him a lot of credit. He tried.
Tell her to pack a bag. Because, yes.
He goes, I'll do you one better. She's going to stay with him for the weekend.
I'm gonna helicopter from her house to the venue.
You know what? This is crazy. And this is just my pal, Seabass. He's paying for tickets and dinner.
No, but I understand.
Jacob, you are in luck because you happen to know the guy who knows the guy.
I understand him not being able to get my mom backstage, but Lou, you work directly with him.
I don't want to say anything, but I think I got turned down by his ticketing department.
You had to speak to his ticketing department?
That's
why don't
what
you
I
text
mean.
Him?
Hey, Lou. Yeah.
Wait a second. Do you not have Sebastian's phone number?
I do, but I don't want to bother the guy.
You talk with him every week.
About radio stuff.
You should be like this. You'd be like, dude, I'm so psyched to watch you from section 114.
Not even that. Just a text that goes, so where exactly are 290 C and D?
Yeah. What does obstructed view mean?
I didn't. Oh, cool. They're doing sitting from behind the stage.
They said they're going to be televising it in a separate room. I'll be able to watch with no audience, Mike.
Oh, dude, that's so funny. He's in a banquet room at the Hyatt next to the Garden. Yeah. Here's a free cup of coffee and your choice of cookies, Biscoff.
he's gonna let you backstage, but you have to take care of his Nana.
He goes, and just for the last half of the show,
Lou, I need you to push my grandmother into the studio space.
How much closer could you be with the guy?
You could be lovers.
We're not very close, Jacob. I'm sorry, but I'm glad I didn't get you tickets because I appreciated it a lot.
You even tried to get my mom, but I'm saying you, of all people, should have been able to get backstage.
Well, you never really fully specify. What did he get your mom?
Nothing. I mean, no, he couldn't. He tried to get her like a backstage meet and greet, like a photo.
Did he get her to the show?
No, they already had tickets.
So he couldn't even get tickets to the show.
No, Jacob, they already had the tickets. And Jacob asked if Lou had its juice to have her.
Why would they buy tickets when they know that
her son walks knows. The halls with the same man?
Yeah. He has his personal phone number.
I don't know why you're laughing so hard, Jacob. Jamie Foxx fucking hated you.
Whoa.
Jamie Foxx didn't hate me. He just didn't know I existed. There's a complete difference there.
Touché. Yeah.
That's very different.
Yeah. Jamie Foxx goes, who? I go, Jacob Attot. I'm at like some, you're at a party later. Jamie, he's at the cellar. You're like, Jacob Attot worked on Foxhole. He goes, I didn't know clue who that is.
That's like, by the way, he said that with the bitterness of that he asked Jacob at one point. He goes, hey, can you get me a small walk on part in Ray 2? And Jacob went, done deal.
Yeah.
Jamie, Jacob ran your channel from New York. We were in many huddles together.
You
don't remember, don't remember that, me?
Didn't he film the new Tyson? He did a Tyson movie.
Did he really?
Yeah, I think they made it.
You know, you have the inside track.
After I left Foxhole, it was over. When I make a break, I make a clean break.
You got no more, Jamie.
Jacob, if that girl leaves and we all leave, would you smell her seat? No. You're saying you're not that person?
I'm not that person. I want to be naughty.
Yeah, Jimmy Carr. Jimmy Carr has that great joke where he's like,
I'm sure it's James.
A lot of Christians believe that Genesis is the word of God. I don't even think Phil Collins is a good drummer.
That's great.
Yeah, Evil Jacob gets it. Yeah, it's Jimmy Carr. Good idiot.
Do you have that video up?
We can dream of you.
Is he okay?
You all right, Jacob?
Huh? I'm sorry.
It's all right.
The video?
Give me a second.
Against all odds?
The fact that we're just learning about this movie is astonishing.
Yeah, this bums me out. I feel like it's been right in front of us. We've never paid attention to it. Jacob, if you will. I feel like there's no volume on it.
Hold on.
Wait, go down and click the volume's off, Jacob. So see on the bottom where it says volume with the speaker? Just click on it. You had it. Everything was all right. And it's all right.
Oh, yeah, everybody. Talk shit about Christine now. I bet you wish she was here now. Jacob still hasn't turned that volume back on.
It's right there. I am a genius.
Do you see where the...
I know where the fucking volume is. Come on.
Oh, man. Now it's in the hot seat. Jacob's in the hot seat.
It's on. It's just, I had to...
You drink it up, bad boy.
Oh, shit. It's fine. Dude, don't freak out. It's fine.
So anyways, you know what I find relaxing? It's a nice... That drop does rule. That drop's awesome for whatever you need. On a very special Michael Chan.
Do you like HBO Max? Do you like the interface and all that stuff?
HBO Max?
Yeah.
Jacob's saying no.
Jacob says no. Jacob hates it. Jacob will come right
with it. The interface blows. It's kind of like it blows.
It was a rhetorical question, Jacob.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were actually asking me.
Yeah, I think it was, that was just a lob, I think, where he's looking for just like a...
Jacob came with hard notes immediately.
He goes, yeah, you think I want to dress like Nick Bargatze for real? I was just
kind of... My bad.
Jacob thought you had a head injury like Charles and Charles in Charge, and your new personality was...
Yeah, so how about that Michael Che? He's like, I can't fucking find it.
Yeah. He goes, I'd watch it if he could navigate the goddamn thing.
Love to find it. I'd have an easier time finding The Wire season 3.
Which sweatshop they designed this goddamn thing in, but throw it away.
Yeah.
Good Lord.
I find HBO Max to be a lovely platform.
I couldn't enjoy it more. I think it's honestly just a choice of so much wonderful programming. Hey, Jacob, can we talk to you real
quick?
As
soon as he started asking.
What was up with that? You know?
as soon as he started asking, Jacob was already going like, been waiting for this moment. I'm
not even going to say, I'm going to take Che out of the equation and say, hey, Jacob, you're going to catch me heat with HBO. What are you doing? What are you doing, guy? You think I don't want to do another special again? Just over here shitting on their interface?
Hey, Mike, you got the ear of the head over there? Because I got a couple of things I'd like to tell them.
Hey, also, got some notes for Lorne. I'm going to send you back with them.
Where's Dream On?
Yeah.
Why is Dream On not on there?
There's no tits on HBO Max. Tits don't live on HBO Max.
You don't buy DVDs anymore, do you?
Talk to the hand.
Do you really buy DVDs?
Jacob just raised his hands.
Not DVD. I buy every CD. I want to own it, and then I load it onto iTunes.
I'm a Redbox guy.
I got to buy a phone.
You buy it in hard copy.
Yeah, but I always buy the CD. I want to own, because I like the album artwork. You don't get that anymore.
Yeah, that's true.
It's true. No, I got you on that.
Wait, so that picture we have when you're young Manson?
It's not so long. Well, it's... Can I admit something now? I didn't realize how scary I looked.
Oh, Jacob, you look scary. You just look like young Charles Manson.
A long time ago. That picture is old, but at one point I used it as a dating profile.
How did your dating app do?
Zero.
Oh,
but shit. I thought,
there's so many
girls. I look sexy. Yeah, I just have no, I'm clueless.
There's so many girls on their phones. Oh, dude, that's so great.
I can't look at it.
You know why you think it's sexy?
I don't want to look at it.
I don't know why you think it's sexy.
It's a t-shirt, I think.
It's also, you're doing this move. You're doing your hands in your pockets. Hey.
I can't look.
I'm gay.
Just a rebel mouse without a cause.
I don't know. Some mouse, you're supposed to love cheese.
Hey, anybody want to go? I'm drag racing right down on Passyunk Avenue.
I got problems with my dad, and I got problems with the law.
One girl, my friend here, she said, I was like, I'm not getting any hits on this site. And she's like, let me see your pic. You know, you might want to go with this picture and not this picture. And I thought to myself, yeah, right. I'm going to do that. Like, she didn't know what she was talking about.
Yeah, right, Cupcake, whatever you say.
She goes, Jacob, you're scary.
She was so right.
Whoa, look at that. Art house director, Jacob.
Oh, shit.
These are all old.
I mean,
I'm Jacob
great.
Fellini.
Rang-a-dang-doo.
Oh, you're talking about
rang-a-dang-doo. Rang-a-dang-doo.
I cut 'em and split 'em. I get 'em out of school. What do they do when they're getting food?
You know, I wear one-piece clothing. It's easier for the kids to figure out. I hang a dang. I hang a doo dang.
You wonder if I have sex in the morning. I'll just tell you, they always get ice cream when we do. I hang a dang. Ice cream for breakfast.
Oh, looks like my girlfriend's crying. She must be up for her midnight feeding. I rang a I hang a hey now.
Well, since my baby teething, I gotta go fuck. What?
My family went young.
Your family went young?
This was the old country, I was told. My
the old country, Jacksonville?
My great-grandfather married my great-grandmother. He was in his 40s, and she was 12.
Yeah! What, Jacob? Yo,
wait,
man.
This is like old, like, what's the old country for you?
That was the vaudeville batats.
Yeah, old country was North Middle Jersey.
The old country. Jersey.
Middle East.
Middle East.
Man.
This was before.
40s and her 12?
It was like normal.
Well.
It was like, they were, the girls were.
Was it just like once you bled, you were good?
Jesus,
from what I'm
Christine.
Told, he allowed her.
Get that on a t-shirt.
He allowed her to play with dolls.
He what?
He allowed her to play with dolls. Like, he was compassionate with the fact that she was
dying. Oh, what a good dude. He goes, sometimes I think you like those dolls more than me.
But my, yeah, that's my other side of the family.
Emotional great-great batat. He goes, hey, I know you kind of want to play with puppies and those dolls, but I've got some needs too.
Charlie Chaplin
we're having corn off the cob tonight.
Because of you.
Because of you.
Another family member was 35, married 13.
Jesus, Jacob.
Christ.
What's up with your family? I mean, Jesus, I come from Viking blood, but nothing that savage.
They just really want to make more Jewish people as soon as possible.
Hi, are you 11? Great. Get over here. You're going to give me a baby.
Fucking. That's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
This is Charlie Chaplin was 16.
Did the big teeth come in yet? Did all the big teeth come in?
From what I'm told, it was...
Wedding pictures with like four teeth. Like, yay. When I was like a little kitty, like,
I can eat apples again. Have you seen pictures of the girls? Like, did they look...
Do they look like he's
super
your, does
young?
Look like your
did they look developed?
So like your grandfather's holding a life-size doll like on your mom's bed?
Were they hot as shit?
This is all to go. There's no... photographs.
Yeah, well, but I get why there's no photographs.
In a rage of jealousy, did a gypsy turn into a life-size doll your mom keeps on a bed now?
Is that your great-great-grandmother?
Is that your great-great-great-grandmother bride?
There's one... they all look... I've seen pictures of my great-grandmother at that age, though, not with her husband.
And oh, you got to see the bachelorette photos?
She looks shocked. That's always a face. Really? I would say shocked.
Yeah, because one day she's playing house and then she's just in it for real.
It also took like an hour to take a photograph, so everybody just looks ridiculous and old.
And you know, kids, you can't hold their attention.
I don't know, Tiffy. The fucking bills are backing up. That's a problem. Just, what are bills?
Yeah.
I like it when I go to the river and I'm in the river and it's cold and then I get out in the grass. He goes, I just lost my first son to typhoid.
We're having pizza, yay!
I like dough and honey.
He goes, you will soon learn to be my bride.
Bride? We're playing dress up like big girls?
Big girl, I'm a big girl bride.
He goes, yes, whatever. God, you're actually less annoying than my 22-year-old ex-girlfriend. She just said literally every five words.
At their wedding meal, everyone else
chicken
was having
nuggets.
So she said, yeah, she had dinosaur nuggets.
The chicken nuggets and mac and cheese.
She wore off the kids.
And she, yeah. Shevitz.
Milkshake.
They had Jewish wine and fucking Dunkaroos.
That's not even old enough to be a woman in the Jewish religion, Jacob.
12.
13.
Oh,
no,
perfect.
It's 12 for...
Fucking perfect. Oh, what were you going to say, Jacob?
No, I was going to end by saying, I do remember my great-grandmother.
You met her?
Yeah, she's only four years older than you.
And,
yeah. Didn't you guys go to high school together?
You've been talking Puerto Rican stats now.
Oh, the batats are getting it in quick and easy.
Had some issues.
They're all born with fat asses.
As an adult.
Because all the batats are born with fat asses.
You don't know.
That's their fault. Yeah, that's their and God's fault. What's in that milk? Because all the batats got batak dunks.
Yeah, bataka dunks.
Batata dunks.
Batata dunks. You met her multiple times?
Yeah, I remember as a kid. Yeah. Had some issues.
Like what? She was crazy?
I mean, now that I think about it, it's kind of understandable.
She had a lot of issues.
She was raped for the first 5 years of her marriage.
She had tons of issues. Really... Prom's coming up. She's raising four kids.
Oh, God. What about all her fucking My Little Ponies she had to give away?
Yeah. She's starting to age out of the pigtails your great-great-grandfather still makes her wear.
Yes, I got you a trapper keeper for your second trimester.
I'm 50. All right, so that's Lou's crest. Let's check out the batat.
Don't even bother.
Two T's, four A's.
Did I do that right?
Yeah.
Don't even bother.
Why no, so no, mad?
We don't have one.
Oh, dude. My God. It's just... the batak crest is just different plastic figurines of dinosaurs. That's not even sort of a lie. But we're not even... Don't even post this. Don't even post this on social media, Christine. Just if... Go... Look up the B-A-T-T-A-T crest. The batak crest is just...
I can't look up.
Go down, Lou.
Oh, that's
just
so,
pages it's upon just pages of toy dinosaurs.
It's just toy dinosaurs.
There's only one page. There's only one page, I think.
It's only toy.
Oh, no.
There's a crest.
Oh, wait. Oh, there's a crest.
It's a... Oh!
Adventure awaits. What? So the best thing you can come up with if you Google the batak crest is finally pages down through toy dinosaurs. Eventually you get to a crest that is four sections.
Yeah.
The first one seems to have a hotel room number that says 220.
Those are Harry Potter glasses.
Yeah, 220. No, it says 221B, and it looks like a doorbell of some sort. On the upper right is Harry Potter glasses, and Harry Potter's like the lightning bolt.
So apparently your family are huge fans of Harry Potter.
The lower left is a scepter with a stone in it.
Dude, let's just go back to the plastic dinosaurs.
And the right and the right bottom is a picture of a ring, and then across the middle is a banner that says "Adventure Awaits."
Well, I'm just gonna say that his family crushes plastic dinosaur toys.
It's go back to the plastic dinosaur toys. There's pages of them, Soder.
It is. We are back from the holidays. We've all had Christmas.
Yeah.
In our respective Christmas places.
Well, before we left, we were giving him shit in the office for his goodbye on that Thursday.
Insane the way you did that.
Just walked off. It was a walk-off goodbye.
It was insane.
Don't agree with you.
You basically did the goodbye.
I told you previously that I was...
Jacob, it was like a side hug of like, catch you in an hour.
Yeah. You did a hug.
That's the hug of Dan when he goes to the bathroom on breaks from the show.
You should see me when I don't see Jay for a week. It's more than just a little side hug that you gave.
It's like La La Land. Everything turns to stars around us, and it's just us dancing in
a... We have to lock hands and sway with each other.
Just dancing in the moonlight.
It's a lot of that. But Jacob, you gave the cigarette toss into gasoline of goodbyes.
Yeah.
Jacob went like, I'm out of here.
It was crazy. Yeah, set off the gas station.
Everyone's like, what the fuck?
It was crazy.
I didn't
realize. I told you earlier I didn't want to stop the show and say, I'm going.
You should have.
Vacation. No.
Why?
You were in the middle of
something.
Who
are you hiding from?
Well, who are you hiding us from?
I didn't want to stop what you were talking about.
Who are you hiding us from?
You're leaving. It's a big deal.
I'm sorry.
This guy.
It's okay.
I should have.
He's hard to love.
It's hard to love.
He's easy to love. He's bad at accepting love.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't like it.
That's what I worked on 2019, and I think you should do the same, Jacob, in 2020. Work on accepting love.
Jacob, please, on microphone, where you stand here. And you love Christine.
I love Christine, and I bake. I mean, it's my passion.
I forgot it is your passion, Jacob.
Christine, I'm sorry. Jay's,
decoration. World's better.
It's a little more intricate.
No, I don't think that was her. I think she just puts out, like, nude pictures.
Oh, yeah, she makes $150,000 a month just putting out some tasteful nudes.
You're right. Okay, God damn it. I'm such an idiot.
Sure.
Come on.
They got knocked off?
Yeah. Oh, my God, it's the Jacob Show. Jacob, you're on the air. Host.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm not a host.
Come on, now you are.
I just come in with stuff.
Now you are. Hit it. You want some music? All right, I'm going to play a bit.
Well, look, I mean...
Coming soon to the bonfire.
But now we're having some tech issues. It's going to happen. Oh, you fuck. Oh, thank God.
I thought what's something going on?
But man, Jacob...
I have a topic I would have gone in, but Lou cut me off. I was right about to finally have my moment, but...
Oh, my God, I think they dropped out. Here's your moment, guy.
Oh, shit. Really want to be put to the test, Lou.
What kind of AOL dial-up do they have over there? This is horseshit. What the fuck is going on?
My gripe, it's not so much a gripe, but a disappointment, and I know this is going to sound weird, but I watch these car shows, Power Nation. It's on YouTube. It's also a MSNBC show, I think. I entered a sweepstakes to win a 69 Chevy Camaro.
Okay.
And I got my soul crushed when I didn't win it. And I know I was probably one.
Great. Now you dropped out with your fucking stupid car talk. All right. I'm going to play some more bits and try to get everybody back. You're listening to Faction Talk 103. Fuck us.
I want you to know, Jay and Dan, that I was rolling. I took the reins, but then my Wi-Fi dropped. I had actually three topics. I didn't win a car that I had entered a sweepstakes for that broke my heart. I was going to name the CW shows that I will no longer watch.
Okay.
Okay.
I like all. First off, two great topics.
All right, so Dan, you're coming through WebEx. All right, now you guys are coming through Codec, and you got to mute your WebEx.
I'm muted, and my video's off my WebEx.
I'm muted.
Internet's connected right now.
I'm hearing you guys coming through Zoom.
No, I have to get off the phone call one.
That's it.
That's the one.
Please.
Oh, just hang up. Just go to your phone and then hang up.
Don't let Jake fucking bore us again with his car stories.
How good was it, though?
It was an emotional moment that I got cut off. Fuck off, Lou. You told me to go.
That was God cutting you off.
You don't know shit.
You don't know shit.
You guys need to hold on because we're going to... All right, there it is. Now we're good.
We're good.
Now.
You're not good because when I bring up WebEx to hear Jacob and Christine talk, we got you guys doubled.
Well, try it now. Try it now.
We also...
Son of a bitch.
Well, I don't know why it's happening now. Well, you know what? I do. It's me, and I just fixed it. I'm certain of it. Yes?
Yes. Bring it up.
You did.
Whoa!
Yay!
Hey, we're back, everyone.
Sorry, I'm a little bit of a tech genius, but we do know that now we can jump on. Jacob, if that happens again and you have to vamp, it'll be great. But what I am loving about this, for whatever reason, we're cutting off on you guys before you're cutting off on us. So we hear you go, what kind of Apple bullshit juke joint is this fucking AOL?
God damn it, dude. The second it dropped and Lou goes, what kind of AOL dial-up bullshit do they have? And you're like, this is fucking perfect.
It's going haywire. This lady's video throws our computer into a spiral.
Yeah, dude. She's our rival. But for everyone to know, Jay and I are both actively ready on our WebEx apps that we've downloaded. So
yeah, we're so ready. That just you have to vamp for a second, Jacob. That's all.
Can you plug my phone in so it's charging?
It was terrible.
Oh, that's me.
It wasn't bad, Jacob.
Right. Well, play your bits next time it drops, Lou. I won't say a word.
Whoa. Jacob, you're actually upset about this.
I tried.
Jacob, whatever you need. You can make whatever you want in that virtual reality. Christine, did we find it? The virtual reality?
It's sold out. Saying that it's sold out and I'm looking...
$400, though, so it's in our range.
$400?
Yeah.
Shut up.
Yeah, it's sold out, though, dude. It's a Japanese company.
I can't believe it's only $400.
Happy birthday, Jacob.
Jacob, good news. Your dick might be
You've
too big
be
for it.
You've got to be a world-class loser to fuck this thing.
Well, you're going to do it, so I wouldn't talk all that shit.
I mean...
He's got like a...
You just got the whole crowd so excited, buddy.
You got to be a world-class...
What?
You got to be a world-class loser to fuck that thing. Do you know how much we're going to make that sound like you're talking about a person who's going to be upset at you? What, Jacob?
Well, you said she was from Juilliard. I once got a lap dance from a girl that was a ballerina at the Met.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. So you, a stripper lied to you once?
No.
Yeah, Jacob goes, can you believe this woman, who was a doctor, mere minutes ago?
No, let me tell you why I believe you. Jacob, I'll tell you why I believe she's probably being honest. Yeah, go. Good.
All right. This was like 4 years ago, and it wasn't at a strip club that you would normally go to. It was some apartment. It was like a billionaire's
So now
apartment.
You're lying?
In the city.
This didn't come up within... It happened within our show, and this never came up.
Jacob goes, I was at an Eyes Wide Shut party with a lot of very important people.
This happened during the bonfire. Yeah, the show was...
Prince Andrew was there with a child. I did nothing.
I didn't know where I was going. Like, I went with... I can't give all the parties away, but... It was, I was just a tag along to this world I didn't know existed except in the movies. It was like really for multimillionaires.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
It was like a very rich person's apartment complex, and each floor was a different thing. The top floor, he had like four levels. The top floor was a strip club. The bottom was a gambling place.
Who's this Gatsby fella?
The one before the floor below that was tailoring. Like you could get a suit made. You could go get a tailored suit and then have it made while you were getting.
And then you could go put it on and bust in it during a fucking lap dance.
But this was an Italian man. This was an Italian man.
This was in the city. No.
It was not a WAP.
No.
It has WAP written all over it, but all right.
Goes, I swear to God, I ever make good, I'm going to have levels of different shit. On one level, it's just pastas. On the next, it's just suits.
There you go, Dan. Dude.
Dude, we're going to have to bleep that out.
It's the CEO of this company.
Jacob, were you able to ejaculate out of your penis out there?
I didn't. I did not. Because, like, it was not like a booth. I'll tell you. So it was out in the open. It was just the most expensive. Like, the couches alone must have cost $30,000.
When you walked up
and
there,
there
did
were
you...
the most beautiful strippers you've ever seen. So, and they were they were not regular strippers. And the one
they were tranny strippers.
The guys that they were dancing to were very Wall Street money. I have money to burn type of guys, and they were not nice to them.
Oh, really?
So the girl that was talking to me, I don't know what this says about my personality. I watched the dance she gave to the Wall Street guy right before me, and she was trying to be nice and talk with him while she was really rubbing into him.
And you rescued her. You saved her afterwards.
I remember the
Captain
guy said,
Save-A-Ho.
Hey, babe, yeah. You want a little less yapping?
Oh,
really?
Wow.
Yeah, I mean,
he goes, you're doing a lot of this and not enough down here. Jacob also walked up on the top floor in a I Fell Off the Titanic and All I Got Was This T-Shirt T-shirt. And everyone else is in Armani. And she's like, this guy seems nice.
Jacob's wearing a tuxedo top.
Yeah, he goes, I'm just here for the finger foods. And she's all like, I'll make you come.
They probably thought you were like a tech billionaire. Who's this autistic guy?
I was a tag along. I was with somebody who was friends with him.
Yeah, like, have you ever heard about sharks?
She just started telling me she was gorgeous and cool. Like, you could tell this was really not her regular gig.
I bet you it is, Jacob.
I'm a sucker for believing that.
You are, yeah. Jacob. I bet you it is. I
think she was. Jacob, did you close your eyes and go in for the kiss at any point?
No, I. At the end of the conversation, she was telling me all about herself, and you know I'm a good listener.
Did you give her money?
Eventually, she said,
"Jacob,
do you want to dance?"
Did you give her money? Did you give her money
for the dance?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I had to pay her. Yeah,
of course you do, Jacob.
Not pay her. I felt bad. Yeah,
there's the rub. Like
Why didn't you say I respect you too much with that story? That I'd rather not. Like, I'd rather get to know you outside of here.
No, she definitely wanted the money, but she wanted to talk to me.
Jacob, I gotta tell you, I was at.
It wasn't all about the dance, Shane.
No, I understand. I went to Hooters recently, and the waitress really liked me. She even sat at the table while she took my order.
Hey, Shane,
so, I mean,
can
it's
I ask,
different, you know?
Did she call you
Shane?
Cutie?
I don't mean to be too invasive. Did she touch?
I totally bought it.
What's up, Jacob?
No, I was just gonna add to the one little thing I would say. I had no money, so I was at this millionaire strip club, and it was driving me nuts because I had to spend. I really didn't have that much money for the strip.
Can you tell us? Can you tell us how much it cost? But
that one, the dance was like 40, and then I had to tip on, and then I had to tip because I felt bad. Anyway.
What did you? What was the total you gave her?
At 60 for that.
Ooh. You tipped 50%.
Maybe
Jacob.
Yeah,
that's why she told
but
you
we
that
were
whole
having,
horseshit
we were
story.
Yeah, yeah, Jacob. That's why she lied about being
a
world famous ballerina.
Yeah, she goes. I'm surprised she got through it without snickering.
She goes, I normally wouldn't charge it, but I got to pay my babysitter. I have three kids, and I'm trying to get through med school.
It's so crazy. My ex is just this violent alcoholic kickboxer. And
it was just nuts that the money meant nothing to them. They were
his name was Manowar.
Hundreds and or if not thousands of dollars. And I was like crying internally that I had to spend $60.
Yeah, no, she was bullshitting. How dirty did she get in the dance? Because I will say the only girl that I drove when I used to do that driving job that was actually in med school and putting herself through med school and she had a nice apartment was the most dangerous stripper for me to take to bachelor parties because she did nothing.
Oh.
Like, she didn't do anything. So this is a place where some of the girls will fuck for money. And then they won't say it over the phone, though, so you're taking a grab bag, you know what I mean? So this girl, didn't, not only she didn't fuck, which is fine, I didn't, that was always skeevy anyway, but not only did she not fuck, she, like, the only thing you could do was, like, she'd pour beer down her tit into your mouth, but almost no touching beyond that, which is fine. I understand all the rules she had. It's just, like, being
the person that would enforce that.
Yeah.
Well,
Would there be a way you could push her boobs together and then pour the beer?
Damn. Old daddy boy, dude. I know you. I know your tricks and your games.
Well, Dan, here it is. I hate to talk science with you right now, but it's fluid, so it's going to slide through wherever. You're going to lose too much of it. Now, it's got to go down the front of the tit. And you put the nip in your mouth, and it bounces off the nip into your
mouth. That's a good trick. Get a little nipple in your mouth.
That's pretty cool.
Absolutely. But it was like I had to enforce a lot of rules on her when some girls were like, just only one finger at a time. Like, oh, you only one finger at a time inside of me.
Hey, if you hear me say ow five times, that means stop.
Yeah.
How far? Well, see, this place, it wasn't booths. They were like super
Jacob, let it go, dude. So, good God.
No. I'm saying, like, how, because Jay asked what I, like, how far you could take it, but you could grab, but I didn't because there were, like, people around.
Yeah, but yeah.
You only spent 70 fucking bucks.
Yeah, you're not going to grab a boob.
I wanted to.
I went to. I actually just went to. I just went to a strip club.
Oh, do you have that clean lube, please?
Yeah, I wanted.
I wanted to.
Anyways, I got to get you out of here. I'll John Wick the whole security staff. You just come with me down the fire exit, okay?
And don't then, you?
Yeah.
How you going to do it? Don't worry about it, Angel. Don't worry. Meet me in the lobby in 10.
Let's see if we can get Jacob to tell that story again. I'm gonna ask him about it.
I think
another hour of Jacob's story.
I do want to know how he ended up there.
I don't think he's giving us all the information.
Jacob, you got to spill the goods, dude. There's more to this story here.
Lou, don't come in hot. And by the way, Lou, we don't need you sniffing around because I know you've fallen in love with multiple strippers.
I'll tell you what, for sure, DJ Lou has definitely come in a public place before. Without a doubt, dude.
I've worn the sweatpants, but I never was able to come. I just can't perform.
You went to a strip club in sweatpants?
That is. What is Pete Davidson?
Yeah. Oh, hey. Sorry, just house with my massive boulder.
No, it didn't happen at that strip club.
Jacob, I can tell you this. You're lucky this show isn't in studio, or I'd be on your ass, dude. I'd be holding you down. I'd be tickling you. Oh.
Honestly, guys. Jacob, I might have to get you a cattle prod for the first time Shane comes on the show.
I've been dying to get a piece of that ass.
He's gonna grab you. He's gonna hold you.
I'm thinking oral cream pie. I'm thinking deep throat oral cream pie.
Is that your genre?
Jacob, can you name one person you were with? Is there anyone's cover you can blow?
No, you wouldn't know any of them.
Oh, okay. Fuck me then, I guess. I'm just on a show called Billions.
No,
you know?
I can't.
Yeah.
I was blown away by the suit floor that I told you about.
It all seems like a weird thing. Like they're doing you for a suit that they're going to bury you in after they fucking kill you on the fourth floor, the fourth level of hell.
Everyone had a good time. Even Jacob was.
Jacob had a
flying around
blasto,
just doing a lot of opiates, just slumming it. You know, met some new friends. Was down at the fucking homeless care center right there downtown.
Could tell you a great frustration I had.
Sure.
In Austin, Texas, regarding Jacob, who I love.
Yeah.
I was telling Jacob, I go, Jacob, there's a fan who I met on Instagram. Mm-hmm. I said, who showed some like possibility that, like, oh, they might be interested in like meeting or hooking up with Jacob. And
is her name,
like,
Rose?
He's like, I'm not doing it. I don't want to dare. He even got upset to the point where I was like, Jake, it made me upset because we were at dinner and I said, Jacob, I'm not trying to hurt you or do something shitty to you. I go, yeah. I'm literally saying, like, I go, he's like, I don't want it. I don't want it. So, this was a fan who was coming to the show, you know. So, before the show, I was bullshitting with her out back.
Yeah.
I didn't know how the guest list works. We just told her to come through the back. And I was talking to her out back while we were all bullshitting out back there. And Christine met her and was like, wow, what a beautiful black. Everyone said how beautiful this girl was.
She was.
And it was funny. And then Jacob comes out and whatever. And I introduced Jacob. And then later on, Jacob says to me, like that night, he goes, when, you know, I'm sure end of the night now, boner's getting a little heavy. He's starting to go like, well, maybe I will change my mind.
He is killed.
He goes, he just killed. He goes, what? He goes, where was that? Did that girl come that said the thing? I go, Jacob, that was the girl outside that I introduced and you shook hands with. He goes, that was her? Oh, man, she was beautiful. I go, what do you think? I'm trying to laughingly hook you up with some slob, Jacob? I wouldn't do that to you, buddy.
Jacob, yeah, she's right there. Yeah, she came out. She was gorgeous.
Oof. Yeah.
Yeah. And then, you know.
Beautiful. And then, yep, and that's it.
Jacob came out.
Sorry, I had my producer hat on.
I'm busy now.
That's right.
And Jacob was busy, by the way. He had to go do his...
That's the reason.
Yeah. He had to do his thing, for sure. And Jacob certainly did his thing on the live show. Do we have a little tease of what Jacob did on the show, Lou?
Sure.
This is Jacob hosting the Newlywed Game that we did against Ron Bennington and Chris Stanley. Who knows who better? And this is Jacob's opening introduction of himself.
Oh, it's time to play How Well Do You Know Me?
Welcome to How Well Do You Know Me? I'm your host with the most, the Don of Dong, the Sultan of Twat.
Project, Jacob, project.
The lip ripper. The chiropractor, because I stay blowing out backs. Jacob Donkey Dick Batat.
Yeah!
Guy murdered. You'll hear the whole episode this
Thursday.
Stole
the episode, for sure. But for the game's purposes, it plays in because there is a song playing in the background. But what we want, should we play the game first and show them how it's...
Or do you want to talk about the copy that Jacob wrote?
Well, maybe we should...
You want to talk about the copy that Jacob wrote?
Yeah.
Let's probably talk about the copy that Jacob wrote.
Yeah.
We should talk about the copy that Jacob wrote.
He's so upset already, Jacob. These aren't insults.
There's no reason for you to break the fourth wall here. Well, can I say on my defense before you rip this copy?
You don't have to defend yourself.
I'm happy with the copy.
Good.
And the process has been for 2 years. I write copy, and then one of you correct it so that it's actually funny. But This one time, you wanted to sandbag me, so go to town.
We didn't want to sandbag you.
Have fun.
At all. We didn't want to sandbag you at all, Jacob.
Really? Dan, can you come to the studio and just make the changes to the copy? Tell you what, buddy, why don't you just come down to the studio? We'll deal with it here.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with that, though.
Yeah,
I knew something was up.
You did? Just like you got that text where you're like, motherfucker.
I guess, yeah, you know, let's handle it here.
There you go. Why don't you come downstairs? Put your hands down at your side.
You know, don't revise it. Just rip it apart.
No, Jacob.
There's nothing to revise. Listen, this is going to run. How about this? Me and Dan will take turns. Let me go first.
Okay.
Trying to read it through, like, you know, as we're presenting a game show to you.
Done.
And we'll see who can make it through this without laughing.
It wasn't long.
No. Let's see who can make it through without laughing at what's happening.
I overwrite so that you edit. You didn't edit this time.
All right, pipe down, Jacob. I need clean audio here.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Hey there, campers. We're starting a new segment on the Bonfire. What are you banging to? Which just, I gotta say right out of the gate, doesn't line up with what we've called this game in the actual thing.
Yeah. But... It's not bad though. So far.
What are you banging to? We're asking listeners to send us video or audio, for those of you a little on the shy side, of you getting it on. Gay, straight, twosome, or threesome. We don't care, but it must have a movie or song in the background. But don't make it easy. We don't want to guess it right away. So save us the "you complete me" speech from Jerry Maguire. It should special to you. But challenging to us. And no foreign films, please. We're average Joe movie buffs here.
All right, that's my turn.
You're both monsters.
We're not monsters. My turn.
Read this funny.
Hold on. No, okay. I'll try to read it funny.
No.
Let me read it funny. No, I can read it funny.
No. Like that. It's making love to the ball scene.
Hold on.
I purposely expected you to write to edit this, Dan. This isn't fucking fair. I knew this was terrible. You're shitting on this. They can't do this.
Spirit of the Airwolf, Jacob. Spirit of the Airwolf.
I got the text when I was in the studio, Jacob.
Complete ambush. Complete fucking ambush. You know, I've always said the same thing.
I've always stood by you guys.
Rewrite it so it's funny.
I've always cared about you.
I've done nothing and Jacob's lashing out at me.
Because I'm dreading how you're going to read the next paragraph.
Fuck the paragraph. The next sentence makes me so happy.
I got to walk out of the studio. I can't hear it being said.
This is so great. The next sentence. To do this. Come on, Dan.
All right, walk out of the studio, string cheese hawk.
Is making love to the mall chasing commando your jam?
Oh, that's my jam.
Or a fun for the whole family scene from Pixar's The Incredibles. Maybe you and your partner gave an even deeper connection, exchanging sweat to Deborah Winger, telling her kid she knows her love as she's dying.
She knows he loves her.
Oh, in the neoclassic terms of endearment.
You said cancer in this. As she's
I'm happy
dying
with the
of
way
cancer.
You wrote it. I'm happy with the way I wrote it.
You can't keep flip-flopping, Jacob. Right. You can't go from mortified to proud. You got to stick with one.
You know what? It was decent.
Maybe Deborah Winger telling me.
You're just all over the map. You're
I'm
like,
beyond happy.
You keep going like, this is terrible. What, hold on. I stand behind it. But also.
Horrific. After you read it, I changed.
Okay. See, it wasn't that bad. Jay, you want to finish this out?
Whatever it is, let us find out. That was all capitals. And in doing so, get closer to you, our listeners. Playing a movie in the background is as comforting as a favorite pair of jeans or hot cocoa on a cold, rainy night.
That's a bad line.
No.
You could have just cut that out.
No, why would I? I'll reiterate. Playing a movie in the background is as comforting as your favorite pair of jeans or hot cocoa on a cold, rainy night. And let me say who you're alienating there, Jacob. As a fat man myself, I don't put on jeans for comfort ever. That's sweatpants, man.
Yeah.
I put on jeans because people are showing up in my life at some point.
It was meant to be read.
How?
Knowingly bad.
How?
Well, hold on. Give me a second to think about it.
So make sweet love, campers, and play a movie while you're doing it. Just remember to tape it, then send it to us.
I'd say video it before
it's that
tape
easy.
It.
Yeah, tape it.
Send your VHS tapes to P.O. Box.
Guys.
Well, I'm older.
Send your videos preferred, which is creepy. That's the creepiest part of the whole thing.
Oh, you want audio?
Yeah, I mean, this is a radio show.
No,
you want to see it. You know, I was thinking of you.
Oh, thanks.
I'm not going to turn on Jacob on that one. You know you want to see it. Yeah.
You know what, Jacob? I'm going to flip-flop on this one and apologize. You're right.
There's something he does in this video that I say all the time. It's the last. He says it twice in the song, and it's also the very last thing he says when the music drops out. He goes, Ascension, Millennium, and then he goes, oh, yeah. And I do that all the time. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Christine's wrestling with her computer in the other room.
She's in a fucking tables, ladders, chair match with her laptop.
Yeah. Everything's intense right now with Christine, so she doesn't turn her computer on. She has to beat it.
Well, I got to tell you something. I was excited.
The title of that article. Oof. Wow. I don't even know what a cisgender is, but I want to find out.
I didn't know Jacob was here. I thought those were drops. I genuinely was like, is that a drop?
Or was Jacob!
That is Jacob. Oh, wow.
Dong. Screen off. I didn't realize.
Dude, I didn't even know Jacob was in the building. I was like, dude, this is a long, very accurate drop that I don't know.
What'd you say? I was so confused by it.
Oh, what'd I know say, what he Jacob? Said. I know exactly what he said.
The article. I said, we're talking about her article, right?
Right.
At some point. I said, I don't know what cisgender is. I didn't know she was identified as cisgender.
Well, take 4 hours and read the whole article.
Guess what? We have an enrollment open now to take the course. You can work your way through.
It's a light read for a 6-hour flight.
Class is in session. Teach me, Christine. You guys want to read that pre-recorded read I sent?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we're doing the show right now.
We're doing the show right now, Jacob.
What?
The show's happening. We had the intro and everything. You were late.
I am late. I was 3 minutes late, but
Christine was saying about audio issues. Dude, oh, hey, everybody.
That was just great. That was just great, Jacob. Jacob really didn't know a customer was in the restaurant talk. Just
right, he goes, just, I can't believe all the mashed potatoes fell on the floor and we just used them anyway. Goes, oh, hey, guys.
Hey, did you guys get that mouse out of the ice bucket? All right, what's up?
Oh, hey, Table 26. Oh,
I didn't know there was a two-top over in Cocktail. Oh, no. That was my favorite. One of my favorite entrances to one of these Zoom shows so far. He's like, "What's up? What's up, faggaronies?" Anyways, what do you guys dick?
I think you just start hailing Hitler.
Dude. He came on and he goes, "I'm going to say it right now: the fluoride in our water is making all these people retarded."
Yeah. What? Hey guys, Earth's flat. How's it going? Right. We going to start this show up or what?
You guys want me to play it up that I'm Jewish again? I know you guys play that character, so nobody comes after you.
I haven't seen this documentary, though.
I'm telling you, this documentary
spins I don't know what that has to do with his movies. I still say you'd like his earlier movies.
Well, Jacob, he's saying
you haven't watched
that,
any of them.
Buddy, Jacob, I've never even thought about not watching a Harvey Weinstein movie because he produced it. I'm telling you, I didn't give a fuck about Woody Allen before he fingered babies, dude. Now that he's fucking walking around with little kids on his hand like cake pops, now I feel good that I saw what a piece of shit he was because of his shit films. I want everybody to know that I turned my volume down on my computer. I was furious with there's insubordination happening here. Jay, I didn't like it at all.
We just turned a corner.
Feminist Christine wants to teach me have a school meet. Class is in session. Listen to tell us your teach me, Christine. Feminist Christine.
Sure, say the word on the read.
Well, this is an awkward read now because I got to tell you, when running a business, HR issues can kill you. Termination suits, minimum wage requirements, labor regulations. I'll tell you what just happened on this break is an HR nightmare.
Oh,
I was screaming for the team to stop talking, screaming for them, begging them to stop talking. Oh, this is stuff for the radio. You guys are bad at radio, I said. I said to us, all of our friends, and we're a week in and all lovey-dovey still. I said, you guys are bad radio people because I'm begging you, yelling, stop.
And
I don't like when they make me.
It's more important than radio.
I'm a dancer. Jacob looked down, tried to actively not enjoy it.
Oh, I know, he's very upset. Well, everyone, it's the bonfire. It's Faction Talk, SiriusXM 103.
Give me one of your smash faces again, Christine. Looks like your hero fucks kids.
Guys, we're coming in hot off the commercial break.
The commercial break was a pure meltdown.
Christine.
Oh,
teacher
dude.
Christine wants to teach us something.
You're missing the point,
Let's hear it.
You're getting very defensive.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
I'm defending Woody Allen. Like
No, you're not worked up at all. You're right. You're totally calm.
Now calm down. Now let's sort this out like fucking adults before Josh comes back. Jacob.
You guys are going to fuck, and Brendan's going to tell us if you guys have chemistry or not.
Yeah. Jacob, you feel like Christine is saying that you think pedophilia is okay because you like Woody Allen's films. Am I wrong?
Did you hear what I heard during the break or not?
I didn't. I turned it off because I was yelling at you guys.
Contort your face at me again, Christine.
Can you take a selfie of that look so I can post it? Because it's really great.
It is great. It is a great picture. But, Christine, what were you trying to tell Jacob?
I wasn't trying to tell Jacob anything. It's just so funny. He seems to really, like, not want to believe it about Woody Allen, which I find
You never said that, and you haven't seen the documentary yet, correct, Jacob?
Listen, Jacob, ordered off eBay his entire catalog of scripts...
I think it's interesting. It shows a fanship. Like you really don't want him to be this guy. And there's a sweetness to that. But it does seem like he is this guy from what we've seen.
Yo, okay. Dan, in this documentary at one point when he's doing an interview. Oh, first of all, Mia Farrow goes, "Are you going to talk to Newsweek or anything like that?" He goes, "No, I wouldn't talk to Newsweek. Why would I do that?" And then just goes like his new interview in Newsweek. Like he just kept lying to her, which is fucking hilarious. He just lied on things he knew he was going to do. But in one of his It's just the most ill-advised thing. It didn't hurt him, I guess, at all. But in the one interview he does, he goes, "No, what? Now I'm going to become a child molester. I had so many opportunities my whole life, and I wait for 57 years old to become a child molester." Like, that's a completely bizarre way to say all of that, guy who writes movies.
Now I'm going to get found out.
That was a lot of words in there. And now of all times I wait because things happen and before and life goes round the clock and bing, bang, boom, and zippity zap, I'm 57.
All of a sudden I like pickles and children. It doesn't happen like that.
Yeah, the little pickles. I like little gherkins. Yeah. Well, look, I know what you're thinking, Jacob. I hear some good news. It seems like in all of his molesting, at least he wasn't gay, dude. So you don't like a gay guy, which I know you're very against.
Yeah.
I know you have no problem loving a child molester, but loving a gay guy is not on your, that is not your palate. You're like, nope. You respect their right to butt fuck each other, but you will not watch their films. And I've always respected that your stance. It's an unpopular one, but goddammit, I respect your rights to have to not watch what you want to not watch.
Your weird sex.
Are you, Jacob, are you going to watch the documentary?
I guess I'll get around to it. Yeah, I'll watch it. Have you watched it, Dan?
We should have told you.
But I'll watch it.
Jacob, we should have told you that Woody Allen directed it. Maybe then you would have ran to watch it.
What's that, Jacob?
I guess you support guys who bang kids then, huh, Dan?
Why? I'm a Mel Brooks guy.
You didn't watch it. You didn't watch the documentary.
No, because I already didn't like him. I told you, I like Mel Brooks. You like Woody Allen. I like Mel Brooks. That's how that
works. Let me tell you something, Dan. I was watching Blazing Saddles while you were still swimming around in your daddy's nutsack.
Yeah, it's true. I know. So, but then you were also into Woody Allen. And then
Then you decided to watch comedy that took place on long walks with women holding umbrellas.
Yeah, you wanted to watch sweater comedy. And were getting schooled in Young Frankenstein. Young
Woody Allen just bites.
You watch cool comedies. Not like me. Honestly, what's Jacob, Young Frankenstein, Dan?
Jacob?
I never heard of it.
You got a lot of heat. You got a lot of anger coming into this.
He's pissed at Christine for really judging hard.
Yeah.
There's your loyal girlfriend. Yeah.
But I can understand liking somebody and then, you know, people talking shit about him.
I still like Marilyn Manson's first 15 years of his career.
Yeah.
You know I also sent this, remember the...
I liked his movies.
No, that's different, though.
And I think
his movies
like
suck.
I like his early movies, the ones that I don't think they're like this love song to New York. They're completely different. This kind of goes with what we're talking about. Yesterday I was saying this line over and over. I've been saying it for years. When I'm alone, there's the scene, it's the very first scene in the movie Deep Blue Sea that we've talked about, Dan.
Classic movie, Samuel L. Jackson.
He was like a Sharks fan.
Always made me laugh and struck a chord with me. It's the opening scene where these two couples are on a boat, an expensive yacht, and there's just these two dildo guys and they're hot girls on in bikinis.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just having a private party on the yacht, just the four of them.
Sure.
Okay.
And the dudes are just loving life, living it up. And one guy turns to his bro and says, "We're having a party, man." And I don't know. That always struck a chord with me. And I said that
makes
all
you angry?
Day yesterday to point it out. We're having a party, man.
We're having a party, man. Well, that was when they, I don't know if you remember, Deep Blue Sea, they really were just setting you up to get to the part where sharks can eat shit. So they're just like, these people are having a party. They get ate. These people are scientists. They get ate.
Yeah. Oh, the shark, that's the scene that the shark destroys the boat and they're about to get eaten.
It's also a good life lesson. But it's also a good life lesson to never call out generically what you're doing because then you're going to die in a very horrible fashion. You go, "Hey, man, we're having a picnic right now.
A steak dinner.
Yeah. Aren't we having fun in the park?" And then,
but it's
kind
of like Chet Hayes. He's just pointing out we're having the time of our life.
We're having a party, man.
Thanks for restoring.
Exclusively use Lyft.
Why?
Because my Uber account got hacked by Russians, and I was like charged from Moscow. So I deleted the app, and I never went back to it.
Well, they had to put a...
I had a Lyft charge going around Moscow, and I've never been there.
How did you discover the Lyft charge? Was it an email?
It's very bizarre.
Yeah.
Luke, get on camera, dude.
Okay.
Do you now?
Okay.
I just have to get the bearings.
Lou, am I okay right now?
Yeah, you're beautiful.
Thanks, bud.
Am I okay right now?
Yeah.
Does Lou sound low or am I deaf?
No, that's because I'm running around.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Jacob.
By the way, I didn't call Lou and bother him because I just let him do him. I let him do what he had to do.
Dude, Florida chill Jacob is my. It's the only way to Jacob.
Because then he'll have to blow a gasket.
Hey, Jacob, when you got the charge from Moscow, did it come up on your app or did it come in your email?
It came in the app, and then I had to call and say, look, I've never been to Moscow. This is not me. And then I deleted the app, and I changed my credit card.
Did they ask you why? And you were like, because I don't trust those Reds.
And they go, whoa, Mr. Jacob, pretty rude of you to say that to me.
And then you yelled out Wolverines and started attacking them.
Dude, you're a full Red Dawn. Full Red Dawn on that ass.
Wolverines.
I don't really want to start anything because now I feel like that combined with the YouTube guy, I feel like I don't want to get targeted.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the same person.
Well, it might be because the YouTube guy just, I don't think he listens to our show. I think he just puts in commercials and he has no clue what we say.
He just sells our show?
Yeah. He just pimps our show out. He's just in the human trafficking.
Are you on that, Jacob?
He's in the radio trafficking game. He doesn't give a fuck.
I'm told he's like Hydra. We took out one head and there's like eight more showed up.
Dude, straight up, we didn't realize that we were that we have been being used by Russian hackers as their...
Jacob went in deep with them and now he's worried about what they're going to find out. And when you have him in the interrogation room, Jacob, ask him if he's the fuck who did your Uber too.
Whoa. Oh. And then put your cigarette out and go, we're going to do this the hard way.
I want you to spit in your palm and put your cigarette out in that puddle of spit. Because I'll tell you what, an interrogation, dude, that sends a message.
Actually,
he's not getting any trouble from this proud American.
Well, is this the Red?
Well, a subject that we wanted to get to that I found very interesting is Jacob watched Top Gun recently, right, Jacob?
Yeah, it was a couple of weeks ago now. I hadn't seen it in a long while.
I don't know why Dan felt like he was interviewing a stranger there. Something that came up recently that I found very quite interesting was, Jacob, you watched Top Gun.
Are you seeing how I'm sitting?
Correct me if I'm wrong, if it was recently.
Are you seeing how I'm sitting?
His legs crossed? Yeah, perfect. He goes, dude, man, look at him. Look at him stems, dude.
I'm showing a lot of fucking thigh today, dude. I'm feeling naughty.
Are those your ranch running
diet?
Shirts?
Ranch diet speaks. Jacob, you recently saw a Cinemax. did that leave you?
It was recently, I believe, correct?
That left you feeling some feelings. What feelings were those?
I think it's all about perspective, man. Like, it does make me think about what I was like as a kid. How I didn't know anything.
Yeah.
How I thought that Maverick had game, or he was definitely confident, I guess. But
sure.
You should never do the things he did talking to women in real life.
What did he do? What did he do to get? Because he beds his flight instructor, so it works.
One of them.
Well, the wrong one.
Yeah, but it does Dan, work.
The most unsexy sex scene you'll ever see. It's such a it's like watching the wall.
Well, I was going to say, and here's the reality of the situation, too. Tom Cruise, while a dwarf among men, just a tiny, tiny man, doesn't really do a great job pulling off, like, I know they call him the sexiest man alive, but you know what I'm saying? He's a bit of a clunk with that shit, but he's very good looking. And then Kelly McGillis is just, he was doing her the favor, quite honestly. I think he worked a little too hard for it. Fucking motorcycle rides on the runway and silhouetted slow music fucking. I'm like, dude, pound her out in a shitter and get the fuck out of Dodge. She's good to go, bro. She wanted it.
Yeah, you're saying he gave her a real... That he's like a rural 7. I mean, he's like a rural
10, not realizing his importance, and he could have just phoned it in.
Yeah. He was doing wave pounds when he was fucking her. He was moving his chest and ass unnecessarily. Damn. Yeah.
The hottest couple in the movie, Goose and his wife. Coolest couple. By far, I would have rather seen those two going at it.
Meg Ryan, let me tell you right now, Meg Ryan's character, Hammered, is a real fucking problem in real life. She is a real fucking problem. Take Me to Bed or Lose Me Forever is I'm going to suck that bouncer's dick and you're not going to do anything about it because you're always gone out on the ocean with your little planes.
Oh, she was committed, man. Yeah, she was, but honestly, and she was sad when Goose died, but she had some new dick waiting to be like, hey, you want to come over? Do you need somebody right now? The second.
Yeah.
The second his head hit that fucking stupid... Dude, fucking faulty cockpit roof.
Quote, she had a quote unquote friend just blowing up her phone when they found out that green smoke was coming out of the fucking ocean.
No, oh my God, I just heard, did Goose die? Shut up. How are you doing? Need somebody right now? Do not even cook. You have to eat, but I don't want you to cook. I'm coming over. I'm bringing food.
And I'm bringing wine, okay? We're going to grieve together.
Maybe, you know what? Maybe we just need to get your mind off it altogether.
You know what's crazy is? A lot of guys say that I have actually like a Marine's body because of the weights I do. Like, look, feel that.
Do you think so? I mean, I'm just a stupid personal trainer, but do I have a good body?
Do I have a body? Oh, man.
Yeah. Goose used to have a body like that.
Well, I'm so sorry.
Sorry.
By the way, I mean, you think they would definitely check on these canopies, like test it a few more times?
Yeah.
That is crazy that it's that faulty. You need it to work, it doesn't work.
Son of a bitch, and I don't want to tell the family this, but we actually got a deal on it. There you go. Can't really say that without us losing our ass.
By the way, I love, and there's so many things where they don't want to show fucking, it looks like, if you watch movies, it looks like, don't even worry, just do whatever you need to do in a fighter jet, because you just hit an eject button, and you'll just parachute to safety. It's no problem. Every time a plane explodes, there's always, when the explosion fades, you just see a parachute guy coming down. Like, I don't think. Also, like I said, I was just blown away by, like, what Top Gun, like, at the time, I didn't think of, and you say about Jacob getting older and realizing things, where it was like, they were just chilling. Then they were like in an hour's turnover time. Like, guys, we have a major dog fight we have to get into over international waters. Yeah. Like, oh, all right, I'll see you guys in a couple hours. I guess it was like the most like fly by night thing.
Guys, this went from where were these MiGs to real deal Holyfield.
Maverick has terrible game in the bar, and also, did you know Iceman is wearing glasses? Which always drove me nuts. Like, dude, you're trying too hard.
Wait, what do you mean he's wearing glasses?
Oh, like sunglasses at night in the bar.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Like, don't mess around with a man in shades, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you best believe you got it made with a guy in shades, so no.
No. Oh, no.
Or maybe he wears them so he can watch for people.
Mirror glasses.
My fucking sunglasses at night joke. Fuck me.
I'm getting it.
Dude, I love your
someone in the car references. Listening right now.
Dude, I love don't your mess with the guy's chance, no.
I'm sorry.
I respect Val.
Are you trying to find anything of his game? Christine says we have to break. This is true.
Oh, let's take a break and we'll come back and watch an actual clip.
Okay.
Some Top Gun? I'll break down Top Gun, dude. There's all kinds of bonker shit in this. I have a friend in the military, 30 delayed? Years, never saw a MiG in his life. He says, MiGs, every 5 seconds they're involved with these MiG planes. I've never heard of them since or before.
My friend...
there you go. And that's actually from the horse's mouth.
It was such a serious movie when I was in high school. This guy was so into planes, and he would tell us how it was real shit, and especially the canopy scene. He was telling us how... You know, that shit can happen. In the lunchroom, I remember hearing him talk about it like it was Schindler's List serious about Goose dying with the canopy.
That's so funny. You guys don't joke around. That actually happens a lot.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's so funny about that statement even. He goes, you know, that actually could happen. Like, yeah. I knew before that scene that could happen. Electronics can go funky?
I would assume a lot of bad stuff can happen when you're flying a jet.
I remember that conversation in the lunchroom like it was today, man. how damn serious he was about it. He had a brother that was a pilot, and so this was the real, this was the most important movie you could watch. I don't know. All right.
We'll, he's we'll like, hey, guys, back. For my brother, can you watch it? Guys, for my brother's sake, can you please watch this?
When we come back, Jacob, I want to see all the problems you have with it. I'll take this thing right to fucking task, I swear to God. Tom Skerritt's finest work, maybe.
It just made me realize that I had more game than I thought. And I know, and I even knew as a kid what not to say.
Yeah.
You know?
If I say one thing I think is funny and I look at the boxes on the screen and no one's laughing, I'm like, oh, man, I just fucking whiffed. Now no one in their car is laughing either. I know if I can make Jacob and the gang laugh. We're doing something, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you need something to bounce it off of a little bit.
Oh, stop, don't laugh at me, Jacob. Stop.
He's so mean.
Yeah, you know, Jacob is the drop king these days. I mean, he's got so much going on. First, we have our entire crew here.
Oh yeah.
Can you give Josh a little Rambo, please?
It's a long road. And it's hard as hell. Tell me, what do you do to survive when they draw first blood?
Oh, yeah.
That's just the start of it. Day and night, you gotta fight to keep alive.
Keeps going. That's all you get.
He's an angel.
Is that Brad Paisley? Or no, it's Jacob.
That was fucking
Jacob.
Oh, yeah.
You want to explain it, Christine?
We just got you a little something that I feel like you have to have. That's all.
There it is.
It's a needle for pushing off.
Actually, if we want to get technical, I got it.
Yeah, it's just one needle. And we go, why don't you step up to the big leagues there, boy?
Melt those down, man. Yeah. Get them in you. And he's slowly opening.
Uh-oh. Got to put on fucking guidance counselor glasses. Let me look at your grades. Do you know what it is, dude?
No way.
Yeah.
Wow. Thank you very much.
Jacob, what is it, Jacob? Your pop-pop glasses while you're opening this is making me...
This is from the...
Is this your video of your last birthday before you died or something?
Oh, God.
Oh, I'm so weak. Oh, this is lovely.
Look, a life touch photo of my granddaughter dancing.
Tell them what it is.
It's from the Roman Palumbo collection.
Yes. Goddamn right it is.
Roman and Sierra fame.
Roman and Sierra fame. We got you a little bit of a wolf necklace. To symbolize your love of Airwolf.
It's a howling wolf.
It's a howling wolf, dude.
Airwolf. Airwolf.
Oh, that's great. Airwolf.
From the Roman Palumbo collection.
Thank you very much.
Whoa, look at the feng shui.
Goddamn right. That sensual motherfucker knows how to make some jewelry.
And in that, I'd like to bring up in our first...
It's called Roan's Collection. Alpha Wolfpack Chain. Oh, man, that made my pee hole snapshot real quick.
We got you a silver...
Reading that is still very douchey.
You got a silver chain now, Jacob, and I want you to know this is the start of what we're going to start doing on the show now.
Mm-hmm.
We're going on a full press campaign here. We need you, Jake. It's ridiculous to me. You're a handsome man. You are in fantastic shape.
Body that won't quit.
Body that will not quit. The things you're able to do with that body, the contortions.
Oh, my God. The core strength.
You have a tongue like a hurricane.
I've heard. Here, let me put it on you.
And what we want to do... is ultimately, Jacob, the goal is we're going to find you a girlfriend.
Hey, real quick, let me tell you the story about the time that Trish kicked the shit out of me when I was 7 years old because I didn't know how to put on a necklace.
Wow. That's abuse, Dan.
Is it?
Yeah, I think that's abuse.
Well.
Hang on, I'm going over my abuse expert, New Jersey, DJ Lou.
Yeah, that's abuse. We didn't need to hear that. You're bringing the whole room down.
That really brought the room down. He's reminded Lou of all the beatings he got for weird stuff.
Seriously, I didn't ask for that.
But look how good Jacob looks in his necklace.
It looks really good, actually.
How can you not? Designed by Roman Palumbo.
Yeah. Those eyes stay sad on the most beautiful woman in the world most of the time. So you know he knows beauty.
It's lit.
It's made from his karate sweat.
It's forged in the metal. His karate sweat's forged into silver.
It's been forged. We found a mystical blacksmith.
Yeah.
who's going to make that happen. Well, here's what's going on. You're very welcome, Jacob, because this is the new you.
This is the new you. I'm beyond happy.
This is the new you. You're dealing in street drugs now. I like that.
Yeah.
You're wearing fucking jewelry with a little bit of flash. You're putting a little fucking flair on the body like an Applebee's waitress.
Dude, yeah.
And what I want...
First jewelry I've ever...
Me and Dan want you, Christine also, very much, and I believe even the Lou's, we want you to find a girlfriend, a wife, someone to share your life with. You have so much to give. You're
so
a great
much.
Guy.
Here's the thing. We have, and this is for the female campers or male campers who have female friends that are lonely.
Sure.
I'm trying to bring love into this show. We've got two great husbands in waitings.
But here's,
number one is Jacob Atop. So we're going to try to get him laid, as Jay has said eloquently.
Yes, here's the thing. We want you to ultimately, because I haven't said that yet, we want to ultimately get you a girlfriend slash potential wife.
Mm-hmm.
But before that, I think what you need, you got to get a little stank on you.
Mm-hmm. They got to know that you're down in the mud.
So they know that you're in the game.
Yeah.
I think, and I don't know the numbers for this, but like, you don't come in with roaring fuck stories the way that we do whenever something happens, or Lou, or Lou.
Yeah.
Black Lou's married now, so.
He's out of the,
but he'll still tell the story. So for Jacob, I'm touring around and talking to these people at the show. Plenty of people say, is Jacob really single? He seems so cute and funny. And he's like, and we always talk about your body and your fucking athletic ability.
Hey,
and
you can kip up. You're the only one that can kip up in the entire cast.
People love
crew,
you.
Whatever you want.
People love you on the air. And I see women that are very cute chicks who seem like they're interested. So we're putting it out there.
Yeah, Jacob. You don't have a prerequisite like me where you need big old cans.
This is round one. We got to get some stank on Jacob. So don't come in here right. These aren't the rounds where you're looking for some long-term
this ain't love.
Deep thing.
This ain't love.
This is a girl who's going to go, I'm coming out with the, it's got to be Jacob's game to lose.
Yeah.
You obviously don't have to do anything you don't want to do.
Yeah, of course not.
But apply if you're looking to fucks.
Oh, also real quick, I just got the confirmation about the Kenny Rogers tickets.
What? It's happening.
Six of us.
You're looking at me right now and tell me that's happening.
I got six tickets.
That's great.
But I'm realizing if Blackley wants to bring his wife, we're going to have to get an extra ticket.
Let's, that's too heavy of information to lay on me in the middle of this Jacob pitch.
I'm so sorry.
It's changed my whole course of my day.
Yeah. It's good news.
So, the bonfire.
At the bonfire. Yeah, I'm used to plugging it. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No. It's the bonfire. This is the email. The bonfire at SiriusXM, right? The bonfire at SiriusXM.com. The bonfire at SiriusXM.com. If you want to apply or you know somebody that wants to apply, tell them to write in. We're going to start looking at some of these tomorrow on the air, but this has to be a...
Guys, here's the thing.
Come reels with it, because
Jacob is... It's interesting because I think you hear a lot of women oftentimes be like, you can't find a good guy. There's nothing but dirtbags online. There's nothing but... And sometimes it's like...
He's not a dirtbag.
You're skipping over the great guys, and Jacob is a great guy. Vecchione's a great guy. We'll get to Vecchione later, because that's husband in a bottle. This is whenever you want a husband. I'll tell you, I've lived with him. He's my common-law husband. Technically, yeah. He is.
And he's good.
It's great.
He's a great husband.
But first, we got to
get... He doesn't hold you back. He lets you keep it open where you're allowed to see other people.
Oh, my God. Single leg takedowns are plenty. The guy is great.
Really a good show of sex.
He keeps you in shape by insulting your cereal consumption.
She had big boobs.
And she had big boobs.
She had big boobs.
That's the one. Can I tell you what? Sometimes people will write me messages on Instagram or shit, and... the ones that always make me laugh are the ones that quote certain things from the show, and the, she had big boobs, makes me laugh. And another guy wrote me, good morning, Julia. It just made me laugh.
Someone keeps saying there's a chance we can get Julia on the show.
Yeah, I checked Twitter for the first time this morning, and I saw a tweet that a guy said he knows Julia.
Let's go full throttle.
Something.
Let's go Julia.
Julia, full throttle. It'd be great if she calls me and goes, no, he was great. He did my crown molding.
She goes, oh, he reframed my doors, and then he blew my back.
He knocked me in the fucking dirt.
Lighting to plumbing.
So yes, we're looking for girls for Jacob. Again, reaching the bonfire at SiriusXM.com. SIRIUS if you're an idiot.
If you're a fucking idiot.
XM.com. I want everybody to get it right, because I'm telling you, I don't think I'm wrong here. You need some offers. Now, I want you to understand this. Jacob, oddly picky about his chicks, I feel like, yeah?
Here's the whole point that people don't want to admit is everyone's picky.
But this is about getting stank on you, Jake.
Oh, yeah.
You can't shy away from love.
Huh?
If love happens, love happens.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I'd always hope that would be the case.
That's the final answer.
Mm-hmm. But I feel like...
I almost said the final solution.
But I feel like before we set you in motion for what's going to be a mega campaign on the show of finding Jacob his...
And I know people are going to be like, oh, you guys doing like a morning show thing, we're trying to get a producer lady. Like, Jacob's our friend, and we see how great of a guy he is.
I'm not trying to get the dude in the studio. I'm trying to get Jacob late. Jacob, I don't know...
if White Lou has a wife.
Yeah.
And I'll go fuck myself.
Well, you know what we're going to do, dude? And you are going to be in Amsterdam in the red light district together in June. I'll take care of you. I'll suck your dick then.
I'll break my pelvis in Amsterdam. Good point.
But White Lou, you get obliterated. So you'll throw your dick in the ring. And you're not sitting there going like, oh, I don't know, this girl's 30 pounds overweight. You'd be like, good, she can let me in and I'll get on top.
Yeah.
True. Very true.
He walks up and he goes, I know Sebastian. She goes, what? He goes,
you know, why would you do that, guy?
He goes, hold on, this is a bit, why, you don't want to blow me? Why would you do that?
Why would you do that?
You look Italian, you know Sebastian.
You got Mediterranean blood in you? Well, why would you do that?
Hey, girl, you look like you shave your hands.
Oh.
Why don't you?
You look like you have goofy superstitions.
Yeah.
Am I not allowed to put my shoes on your table?
The Bonfire at SiriusXM.com. Listen, you're coming to the game, you do whatever you want to do, but come with the idea that Jacob's looking to fucking dip it in.
Anthony just tweeted at the Bonfire, it's just a raining of sausage, and he wrote, you're inbox right now. Okay, here's the thing that I didn't tell you guys. Jacob's down with dick, too. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Look at that right there. Stephanie Falcone, one of our top campers, counselor.
She wrote, I can attest, Jacob's body is no joke. I lathered him at the one-year anniversary show, and I'll tell you this, zero to no body fat.
Maybe somebody might say that was an act of God.
Yeah. He's one of those guys that works out during work.
Yeah, he comes in after a workout.
It's crazy.
Sneaks down to the gym, blasts out his delts, you know, works his pecs, gets back up here.
So you're getting a guy who's got stamina, he's got range. I bet he shoots ropes. He's a dripper. He's healthy. I think his body functions well.
He's also, he's good to family. That's why he's going to be in Florida next week, because he likes his family better than the show. He has a job. He runs the Comedy Central radio station.
Dan, I want to sell that jizz thing a little bit harder.
Okay, yeah, sure.
He's very clean. Now, you come into my party here, my urethra's got to be plugged with all kinds of God knows what. Glutens.
Mine might as well be a soda gun at a McDonald's on a highway stop. It's just gunked up.
Yeah.
Well, I should tell you, Shane is the reason I know about Sierra Sky, and now we know about Sierra Sky.
And now Jacob's completely obsessed.
He quotes...
Maybe more with Roman.
Yeah, he quotes Roman all the time. But also, when Shane came in to do the show, Jacob walked over and shook his hand. And just
he paid respect.
He goes, I want to thank you for bringing him into my life.
You know, it is pretty funny.
So what was the final group? Who were you left with?
Me. Me, Shane, Christine, Jacob.
What a fucking squad, dude.
Yeah,
ruled the fucking streets.
You guys are like Michigan. You guys are like the fucking...
What?
You guys are... Sorry, Notre Dame.
Oh, yeah. I heard Jacob and Shane had a train ride home.
Oh,
yeah,
so what? So funny.
So you guys parted. Jay and Christine go back to the East Village. Where do you... Jacob and Shane...
Now it's me and Jacob on a journey, dude. Jacob just led the way. I had no idea where I was going.
Was Shane wacky the whole ride home?
Well, just even walking to the subway, he kept turning to me and saying, dude, are you trying to fuck me?
Well, that started, I was like, oh, you guys are both going back to Astoria. You should take the train together.
Yeah, Jacob goes,
what's the first?
Jacob goes, fuck me?
Get me an Uber, I'll fuck you.
Jacob's like, I don't know, you feel like maybe taking a bath, like a dual bath?
See where it goes?
So then we get into a train station, and I'm just following him, because if he wasn't going back to Queens, I have no idea what was going to happen. I would have just laid on the street.
Act you like that, huh?
Hit me hard, too. Fucked up. And I, you know, smoked a blunt and fucking vape. And I was drinking. I was fucked up. But
that's a lot, yeah.
We're on this platform, and he keeps walking to different train cars. And I'm like, why are we still walking? Because we walked pretty far.
We're trying to ditch Shane.
And then I realized what he was doing right when we were walking into a car, because he was fucking walking around trying to find a hot chick to stare at the entire train ride.
Did you have sunglasses on and pull them down on your nose? I go, oh, yeah.
Which is the weirdest behavior.
No, Shane, because you'll talk him up, though, if you have a girl. You're in the right place to go over there, and you'll try to make a conversation. And then he can go, that's my friend Shane. He's all fucking whacked out.
No, it backfired for him pretty bad.
Oh, no.
while we were walking into the car, I was like, dude, did you just fucking make us try to find a hot chick to stare at the whole time? And he was like, yeah.
And he said in front of the whole car, dude, that's creepy as hell. That's creepy as fuck.
Did anyone react to it?
It was Halloween. I wasn't trying to find anyone. The car was rushing by.
I
just noticed a Poison Ivy costume. And what am I going to do?
You happened upon it.
Yeah,
I
stumbled
guy who could
into
fuck
it.
This girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
It's true.
Sometimes the Lord provides.
So I wasn't. It just so happened that I saw it, like, as the train was going
by.
He, like, walks fast to find the car that this girl was on.
I get it. I get that.
Oh, good.
I get
that's
it.
All. I'm not being weird.
I thought the
Shane
way
was
Shane,
telling
the way
me
Shane,
that this never happens, people.
The way Shane made it sound was that, like, fucking Jacob's walking down the platform with a toothpick in his mouth, like,
flipping a
there
coin.
She is.
Who's the next victim?
He goes, there is my next special lady.
So then while we're getting into the car and I say that, I'm like, dude, that's fucking creepy as fuck. This girl, this hot girl in front of us hears us and starts laughing with us, which is really funny. So then the three of us are on a train. All three of us are laughing. And then there's a homeless dude sitting next to Jacob.
He starts laughing.
He had too many mushrooms. He was asleep.
He took life mushrooms.
It was homeless guy, Jacob, me, sitting on this bench. So I started pushing Jacob into the homeless guy the entire ride. And every time I would start.
That's such a hilarious drunk sober guy move.
Start to nudge him a little. He'd be like, stop.
Shane, you're pushing me and I'm about to shove back. You keep pushing on my shove. You're
going
to
wake
up.
Back.
You're going to wake up the bull. Not on All Hallows Eve. Not of all nights. The night where I go the most evil. Jay, you're fine. Stop touching it.
No, I'm putting the stuff on it.
Oh, waking a homeless guy on the train is terrifying. That's my anxiety.
Dude, I saw
the roof.
Yeah. How could I text and tell you I'm going to be late if I'm underground? You know what I mean? What do you mean, a cliffhanger situation out of there?
Oh, I would have
even that took
it.
2 hours.
If you were late, I would have just carried it, dude.
Hell yeah. When there was only one set of footprints in the sand.
Yeah, just me and Jacob just like, so what's up?
What
I
is
don't know,
up?
Man.
Me, Shane, and I.
No pressure at all.
No pressure.
Get the fuck out of the way.
And he comes out of turn number 4 to claim his first
the last turn.
Series championship. It's Joel.
Yeah!
Player or a football team before, or any like a sports team. So I don't
you
know.
You
never
got into football?
Not really.
Oh, Jacob, man, you could have fooled me with the way you celebrated in that.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a little.
I watched my daughter.
Effeminate as fuck.
That's why I don't want this on the air. That's why the video's not going out.
Jacob, I watched my daughter, who I love more than anything in this world, I watched her come out of the womb.
Yeah, it's not,
and I didn't emote that much.
It's not right what I did. I'm not. There's nothing.
It's not wrong. I'm telling you, I'd love to have a passion in something in life like that.
But that was
Eagles
know,
won the Super Bowl.
Years coming.
Eagles won the Super Bowl and 25 years coming. What do you mean?
Meaning, I guess I was just building
you've been
up. Like
this guy
I just
had a child.
I just haven't had it. I'm trying to think, like, since I've been,
an
adult,
you
know?
Did you molest?
I've never celebrated about sports like that. I think maybe the Mets won in 86. I was happy, but that's the last time. So, yeah, it's been a
1986.
While.
1986.
Yeah, it's been a while.
And you picked this guy as your guy. You picked this guy as your guy,
like from the start, once I started watching NASCAR.
Right away, he was your dude.
You were like, he's cute. He's cute.
He was my dude from the beginning.
Why? Jacob definitely, he needed to know that Christine would, in fact, fuck this guy. It was important to him to know that.
I can't wait for Joey Logano to take a hard right on the track and fucking burned to death while you're watching.
Oh no. Oh God, Joey, no.
I would cry. I would do it, say exactly the way you just said it.
I would say, see Jacob oh, God, fall into
Joey,
a,
no.
Just fall into a self-hug on the floor.
Oh.
Oh, Joey, no. This is all I fucking had.
I would be miserable.
I wanted to get you a hooker right afterwards. I wanted you to... That you should have fucked last night. You should have fucked something last night, Jacob. You were so into it.
I would have.
It was very exciting. We all were excited for
I'm
you also.
I'm glad you came. I'm sorry. Shane, I wish you'd
know,
been there.
Man,
it'd been
I
great
wish.
To have you there and watch me do that.
I would have been so happy, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, Jacob made a tapenade.
I would have been cheering.
Of food.
I would have been cheering for whoever was close to beating Joey as hard as I could.
Hell yeah.
Oh, where is Jacob? I'm surprised he's not here fucking hard-eyeing you. I think Jacob has a thing for Shane.
He does love Shane.
He does, right? In a way,
we would make good lovers. Just an old man and a young bull just getting deep up in him.
Dude, you would just pounding him, feeling
just
all of him.
Deep inside of Jacob.
Feeling his whole body wrapped around yours.
I'd make him scream like Logano, dude.
No one can make him scream like Logano.
Right when it first penetration.
Would you ever let Jacob fuck you?
Yeah, dude. I'm a generous lover.
So, but would you start or finish?
You're the
bigger guy. So you think if you go first, maybe there's not a round, but you let him go first, there's a guaranteed second round.
Yeah, I would take him from behind first.
You wipe your pre-cum on your dick?
Dude, I get thrown off every time. I would finish. Yeah. He might finish.
That's the same time.
That's how strong I would be.
My friend, we used to watch high school basketball games. My buddy would get in my ear and tell me how he would fuck one of the dudes on the other team. But like in a way where he'd be like, it's not gay because he would be missionary and his dick would rub up against my stomach, therefore getting him hard. And he's like, what if someone did that to you and you enjoyed it and you didn't want to? I was like, stop. We'd just be watching a high school basketball game.
He'd just be in my
ear like, ah, dude. Jacob, we were talking about you and Shane. Sexual chemistry. It's palpable. Dude, he's dressed up today?
Yeah.
I know. Listen, I know Jay. There's jealous Jay, but I'm jealous Dan now.
Yeah.
You didn't throw that on. That's a pressed shirt. You ironed that.
Did you get that? Thanks. Where'd you get that shirt?
Peter Manning. It's for guys under 5'8".
What the fuck is that,
dude? It's for guys under 5'8".
Really?
I defy one.
This is a
tiny man.
This is a large and tall. I didn't know there was a fucking little person shop.
Why do you got to put it like that?
I don't know. What's the soft turn about that? Is it Peter Manning? Just say you got it at Peter Manning?
It's changed my life, this store.
Hello, welcome to Peter Manning.
Well, you don't have to drop your voice.
Hey, I'm Peter Manning, and I'm 5'2",
you know
but
what?
Stout.
It's
do they give you lollipops
cut.
When you walk in?
It's about proportion.
Guy.
Are you good at making chocolate?
Michael J. Fox buys clothes there.
Well, I don't know if he buys them. Someone.
I don't know. He's on the website.
Yeah.
Damn, that's so demeaning going in there. At least big and tall, they're not hiding it. They're like, yo, are you a fat fucking, fat as fuck? Get in here.
Hey, house, you want to buy a fucking jacket?
We got some big dog t-shirts for you.
Oh, man, you're going to be dead, so this material's not that good. Hey, Andre the Giant disease. Your heart's going to kick.
Hey, freak, get out of Sears. Come down here. We got some fat shirts for you.
Yeah.
Little guy, they had to hide it. That sucks.
Well, they have to put name in front of it.
Like, are you going to Peter Harrington? Oh, it's Peter Manning.
Tiny shirt.
Dude, what the fuck? Peter Manning. Well, good for Peter Manning. He's a little guy with a fucking head full of steam.
Normally, I'm Banana Republic, but I'm telling you, it's all about the proportion. Like everything you like.
It is. When H&M.
Everything's wider, and they make the shirts make. Like a regular shirt will be a dress on me.
Mm-hmm.
It's just too much.
So
too
if you
long.
Sleep over at Shane's
I
house.
I can just see him walking out in my sheets camera down to his knees.
He goes, hey, baby, is there any iced tea in the fridge?
Shane rolls over. Morning, lover.
Oh, I'd be filling that goatee up.
Yeah. You guys would have passionate sex.
I love it definitely when a guy compliments my vibe.
The post-sex would smell like ham.
Of course it would.
Open butt and ham.
Pre-sex would smell like ham. Yeah. There'd be a lot of ham smells.
Shane and Jacob doing the whole like, yeah?
Yeah?
Hell yeah.
No. Hell yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
I knew you. Shane's you scratching.
You're in my fucking wheelhouse now, Jacob.
Jacob's getting handsy. Mike, for you that doesn't know, Jacob and Shane have a palpable sexual energy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's been a lot.
Everybody's jealous when me and Jacob walk in.
Everyone knows. Jay gets jealous when he's here. I'm jealous now. McCusker's jealous. Yep.
So McCusker's just rock hard, dude. I split hose with my dogs, dude.
For sure.
Me and McCusker will go halvesies on you.
Jacob, I'm just Jacob trying to smile it off.
He's like, I'm pretty sure that.
Yeah, definitely. Whole squad's going to
Jacob,
get it.
Would you feel you're being attacked by toxic masculinity? Would you say that's what Matt and Shane are throwing on you? Do you feel that?
Yeah.
Well, you know who's got your back? The people at Gillette. You know, the same people that have a stadium in Boston where a bunch of dudes are getting brain damage. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at Jan.
Why you make that face like that?
Yeah, dude.
I love Liz. We're she's up here every week because she does the Raw report.
Oh yeah, does she every week? Do you catch yourself just kind of?
I bet you know the time she walks in, don't you?
Yeah, around 3:30.
Big deal. Ooh.
It's one of the last guys you want
every Thursday
to know your schedule.
So
this fucking serial killer,
Jacob. Good news is he's super into guns now.
What?
Dude, I'm so excited. I can't wait.
For guns?
Better news is, Shane.
Rifles, not guns.
Guns are the shit. By the way, as many guns as you can.
We also talked about them. Their Fifle goes west. They're 22s.
They're for mice. They're for mice.
22 gauge.
Yeah, they're if you want to piss off a deer.
Can I tell you?
Dude, I'm in a real jealous Dan mode today. Jealous Dan.
What are you jealous about?
Just, you know, crew's not coming down on time. Everyone's being a little chippy.
Crew has been a real piece of shit today,
to be honest. Thank you, Shane.
I've noticed it big time. Jacob's been giving me nothing but attitude.
You know what it is? Is Jacob's soaking in puss.
Yeah, he's laying in a baby pool of snizz right now.
And
Yeah, and then now he's just like, you're right, it's the big dick confidence.
What's up with you, bro? I heard about what you were up to down in Austin.
What's up with you two?
Were you kissing girls?
He kissed a lady.
Yeah.
On her face.
What do you think's wrong with me, dude?
You're a little upset, aren't you?
You don't like that?
Why would I not like that? Or why would I like that, dude? I want you to be mine. I want that fucking cherry ripe when I pop that fucking, when I break you off, dude. Pop in that butt.
Are you genuine him?
I'm going to send a group text to everybody and be like, oh, Jacob's fucking women's soccer party is canceled, and I'm going to come over and fucking uncork one in. I'm going to save up for a week. Be coming out of your nose, dude. Fill you up, kid.
Yeah, dude. Give him the Twinkie. Make him all cream on the inside. Yeah, I love it.
Normally, he's happy to see me. He made out with a couple chicks. You finger? You finger down Texas? No. Do the old Texas two-step?
Dude. Uh-huh. Little digit dance? Huh?
You didn't finger anyone?
I was invited to go two-stepping, though. I'm going to do it.
You excited about that? Yeah, you got to get boots, though.
Like Texas two-stepping or like a Crip blood type thing?
You're going to rep his set.
Was it a blood?
What up, Marky-ass Busters? It's Jacob Batat.
Hey, you Marky-ass Busters.
Hey, what's up, everybody? You guys know any slobs coming around the way? Repping 236. Gang.
Dude, if Jacob just started seawalking hard. All right.
So what's going on with the ladies?
I mean, that's it right now. Yeah.
Just making it. You made out a little bit. Now you feel any tits? You feel any tits over the shirt tits?
That's a good question. That wasn't
over
asked.
The shirt tits during a makeout.
I love it. I love
pretty
a
good, much mandatory.
I'll do even in a
quick squeeze. Keep
butt
moving.
Grab.
Butt grab.
Butt grab. I would probably say is the number one step in a makeout. You go for butt grab.
I go
first.
Butt grab
before boobs. Boobs second.
Yeah.
You go butt grab first.
See what's
boob
going on.
Grab second.
See what? Hey, are we allowed to grab the butt?
What if there's hip push into you? You're like, yeah.
Well, then I'm gonna over the pants finger you for sure. Give a fucking pat. Give a pat. Kick the tires.
I was gonna say check the undercarriage. Yeah, that's good to go.
I kick the tires. I'll
there she
it.
Is.
What's this?
Where are you? What are you riding with?
Huh?
What you packing in here?
It's PSI on this thing. Huh?
Yes. You ready to shoot?
I'm gonna fucking shoot.
Jay was mocking my over the pants hand jobs, but those
over the pants hand jobs are the fucking best. Man.
Thank you. What? I really felt like I was alone in here. No one fucking stood up for me.
That gets me going.
Over the PHJ,
I almost require an over the pants hand job.
Yeah, dude.
Almost every makeout.
Dude, it's just like priming a lawnmower.
Mm-hmm.
You're like,
especially you just rub the top of it because it's against your pants.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, it's nice. All right.
Yeah. Well, see,
cooking with gas.
That's why we hang out.
What's going on?
That's why we hang out.
Jacob, you got to start getting more over-the-pants hand jobs. Embrace it.
Oh, dude, I'm with you on that.
Oh, yeah, you fucking jizzed your pants that one time.
Nobody got to that part. I didn't even get up that high.
Oh, man. You know what's crazy is if she listens to the show, do you think she knows? Do you think she heard that story? Oh, thank God.
No.
Yeah, that's a tough one for a lady.
Do you think she listens?
No.
Good. All right. But a friend does.
Are you sure about that?
Oh, well. You mean the one the...
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
He forgets these hoes, dude.
No, I thought you meant the girl who I had that experience with in...
Oh.
What experience with?
When he cummed it, when he came in his pants.
Get overexcited.
That's what you call it? That was an experience?
Yeah, he goes, I just had an experience.
I don't like to...
Sorry, I experienced
it. It's hard for me to say out loud.
Yeah, I get it.
Get overexcited.
There's nothing wrong with that.
What, coming in your pants?
Just a pre-jack? A hard...
It wasn't a pre-jack. I think it was full nut.
Full semen?
It was so long ago.
I feel like it was a few months ago.
It was less than a year ago.
It was so long. It's like another lifetime.
But look at that. In less than a year, how much Jacob's rebounded. He's gone crazy. From just painting up jeans to just making out and digit dancing down in Texas. Just give it a nice pussle slap over the jeans.
What is this? Hey, so lady, funny. What the fuck is this?
What do you got? It's such a funny jaw underbite fucking talk. What is this? What is this?
Is this mine? Is this about to be mine? Is this Jacob's twat?
Is this
Jacob's patwat?
Is this where I play?
Am I about to set up shop in here?
Huh?
Huh?
Base camp. Base camp.
I'm about to fucking climb in there. This is base camp, lady.
Slap her pussy.
I'm gonna get a Sherpa to guide me up in here.
You know what my Sherpa is? My dick. Yeah, you ready for the Sherpa? Base camp.
This is my Sherpa.
All right. We're going to take our first break. Shane Gillis hanging out. It's the bonfire.
Jenny was there.
Jenny.
Wow.
Who the fuck's that, dude?
She works at Del Frisco. She's a very beautiful actress.
Do you like her?
We all like her.
Yeah.
She's an actress.
She came in here and mowed down the whole studio.
And she's done some topless nudity. Did you shave your pubes for lunch?
No, I didn't know we were
Great going. Call.
Did you shave your pubes just in case?
I didn't know I was going. Just to feel generally.
Did you try to jump her out?
I felt good about myself in there.
Now, I'm telling you, that girl's hot. She has ears that can support a 1,200-foot glide.
Yeah. She can free jump. She just takes off a knitted cap.
But I mean, she's very, very talk about your bitch like that, dude?
Super hot chick.
You're going to let him fucking trash your bitch on your V-Day? So your plan, you don't have any plans after this?
No.
I might come over to your house in Queens and stuff you, dude.
because
call that homophobic.
It'd be great to see Jacob on Monday, and you're like, how you doing? He's like, Saturday was a nightmare.
Yeah.
It's not the day after the impact. It's the day after the impact. That's when everything settles.
That's when some of the swelling goes down. The bruising really sets in.
You know, some boxers die 3 days after their fight? That's how I felt.
Concussion style.
Oh, man. Let Shane come over and give you the gift of love.
There's no way he's homophobic. My favorite photo is our...
No way he's homophobic. Thanks, bro.
Yeah, man.
Yo, Comedy Central, what up? You sure you guys want to put me on air?
It's gonna be fun to see the Comedy Central logo over your face.
It's going to be like one of those drug dealer shows.
Jacob, happy birthday. How do you feel? Yeah.
Do you want me to come over and stuff you?
I'm going to come over and stuff you.
Jacob, if you want your birthday present.
Everyone needs to see our pride photo again. That was my favorite, one of my favorite photos.
Oh. You guys hug him?
Yeah.
Santa Claus, everybody.
Santa Claus?
Oh, wait.
What was that?
Santa Claus?
Oh, did you wake up little Jacob?
Did little?
Oh, no. Is little Jacob awake?
I can't see him.
He must have heard your sled.
Santa Claus, is that you?
Where's Jacob? Where's he at?
I think I see him over there.
Oh, Jacob, what are you doing awake?
That's not him at all.
We left the skull out for Santa Claus.
Oh, there he is.
Santa!
Santa,
it is you!
It's little Jacob.
Little Jacob, get up here. Are you all sleepy, buddy?
Santa Claus!
Hey, champ, get up here.
Come on, buddy. Come on.
Hey, bud. Got
your jams on? Why don't you sit in Santa Claus's lap?
You and Jacob shared such intimate space yesterday. It was my favorite part of the of the holiday show was Jacob revealing and coming out to you to the sweet tender song "Oh Holy Night" playing while he walked in his pajam jams across the entire club to come sit on your lap, which, disclosure, you knew was happening.
I knew it was happening.
And yeah, it hit you different than you thought.
It, that was one, like, we talked about it, and I was like, all right, this will be funny. I'll do the usual. I'll be like, yo, Jacob, I'll fucking stuff you, dude. I'll fill you up.
Yeah.
But as soon as it got real, he and I saw a grown man in a onesie, like, talking to me, like, hey, Shanty, is that you? I was like, bro, this bit has gone too far. And then he was sitting on my lap. He was getting real comfortable.
Got real?
He was, like, Shanty snuggling in there. Oh, my God. And I'd, like, really I was trying to look away. I was trying to look away.
Yeah.
He'd say something, I'd look and see his face in there, and it was very off-putting.
In character.
Yeah.
I looked at you.
Yeah.
You're completely doing it now, still.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Oh, he could sink right back in. This guy's like De Niro.
Good Lord.
Daniel Day-Lewis. I was in character, man.
Daniel Gay-Lewis.
You scared, buddy?
You don't have to be scared. Santa Claus is here.
It's Santa Claus.
I've never been so hard.
There you go. Santa Claus. Jacob, do you want to ask Santa Claus for something?
I love you, Santa Claus.
All right.
Santa, did you come all the way from the North Pole?
I gotta be honest, I thought I was gonna be able to handle this bit. But how old are you, dude?
There will be cum.
You were here. You were so. You were definitely over
my
that.
My left
in,
nut.
You were over that in 35 seconds.
When I was over that when I saw him walking to the stage. Well, I was like, this is going to be rough. Dude. Yeah, man. Seeing him grown like an older man in a onesie.
He's not an older man.
Pretending to be a little boy.
He just hurt his feelings so much. He's not an older man.
How old are you?
Forget it.
How old are you?
I don't even care now.
How old are you?
You couldn't go along with the bit, huh?
How old are you?
Well, Jacob, he's not the real Santa. Is that what you're figuring out right now?
Yeah. Look, I did what I was asked to. I mean, it was.
No, you're right. You're right. You did
and
exactly
I said,
what you were supposed to do.
Go as perverted as you need to.
Also,
go
a girl got up. A girl from the audience got up to ask Shane for Christmas. But he said, you know, tell us people what you want for Christmas. Tell Shane what you want for Christmas. And they lined up. And the first girl, smoking hot chick, by the time it got to her list of things, it was like real shit.
Yeah, she asked for real gifts.
She asked for like material objects specifically.
Like what?
Not even like, she didn't even ask for like ideas, like, you know, peace and happiness for everybody here. Whatever. It's like, she asked for tangible. She's like, fucking shoes from whatever place.
I want this Fendi bag. And if...
What was the place called?
I don't remember.
Oh, come on. Someone's got to remember this.
I really would love anything from Van Cleef & Arpels or David Yurman. Or
do you really? Do you think I'm real Sam? Like, are you hot enough that no one's ever told you?
Only hot girls still believe in Santa?
Wait, Santa's here?
Yeah. Literally, I met him in Argentina with my boyfriend, Bo. And I was like, babe, that's Santa.
He tried to neg me on stage, but whatever.
I was like, ew, you fucking hang out with reindeer all the time.
That's funny. That's
Those are real shit. Those are retard horses.
Yeah, you got the special out. You can drop the R's.
Yeah. Oh, I'm out of the fucking cage. Welcome back, ether. 2015, Danny Soads.
It's in the ether now.
Yeah. That's why, is that why you were so hesitant? Probably got tricked before by Santa.
I mean,
like, sit on my lap.
Yeah.
Like, not I'm again. Not...
Would you like to come to Lavo with Santa?
Is that a no? I've just never heard
Santa's got some drink tickets for upstairs if you want to hang. Santa's friends with the promoter. Santa knows the guy who owns this place. There's a sick loft upstairs. Dude, Santa, if you want to check it out.
Santa trying to get pussy might be my favorite new thing.
Dude, Santa would have a sick loft.
Yeah, he goes, slowly, you've never...
He can afford a place with bedrooms, but he likes the loft.
Yeah.
He likes the open layout.
Santa likes when people watch. it means he's bringing joy to little boys and little girls.
Oh, ho, ho, we're all adults here.
Mrs. Claus is cool with a lot.
He slays the gash.
Come on, that's why I said it. That's why. Old exclamation point, Norman. Miss, I do not believe he has access to those things.
What? Anything a little more, you know.
I'll get you anything you want, I swear to God.
Now
I'll fucking kill myself for you. Is that what you want? Is that what you want from me, bitch?
Fran, yeah, knows. She asked me for some type of. I thought it was a bag. I don't know. As soon as she gave me like a real request,
but I want to see what
like,
it is. I want to see what a chick that hot comes up and is willing to put out to the world. Like, I deserve this for what, you know what I mean? Like,
to me.
Before asking, yeah, like, she didn't come in and goes, I wish the wildfires in Los Angeles would stop.
Shane's like, you know, I wanted to get you that bag, but how about this extra large Notre Dame hoodie? Would you settle for that? Don't worry about that bleach stain. It's part of the character.
Which yeah,
each one's
Jacob.
Authentic.
No, that's
true.
The
game worn.
That's the thing. I didn't see anything that was going on. I could only hear it because I was in the kitchen hallway. It was just me quietly standing there in a onesie with a greased up Tim Capello next to me.
Yeah, please. You and me both had very interesting Tim Capello experiences.
Dude, please tell Shane yours. This
I walked
was great.
Back there. I walked back there to get into the Santa Claus outfit. And Tim was just sitting there. He looked like a bouncer. He was wearing like an all-black outfit. And he was just listening to something on YouTube on his phone. He was holding his phone up to his
the
ear.
Rocky theme?
And I walked back. I was like, hey, can you watch the door? I'm going to get changed. And he kept playing his fucking music into his ear. He didn't put his phone down to listen to what I was saying.
Yeah, everybody stays in character except listening. For you, Shane.
He kept listening to it. And I was like, can you fucking hear me? Like, I'm making eye contact. And then he was like, yeah, I'll watch the door for you, but I got to get changed too. And I was like, that's odd for somebody who works here. So I was back there dressing up like Santa, and he comes back and tosses on like a leather thong or some weird outfit and starts lubing himself up. And I was like, whoa, dude. this is different
damn.
Than what I'm used to.
You thought he was a worker.
Yeah, what is
hey, Chief, keep an eye on the curtain for me, huh?
You tell me he doesn't look like a bouncer?
Sure.
That guy 100% looks like a bouncer.
In like a roadhouse type of place.
Yeah.
Yeah, where it's more his skill and knowledge of funny. He's Wade Garrett. He's not Dalton from Roadhouse. He's Sam Elliott.
Yeah.
It's not so much that he's a good fighter anymore, but he just knows he has the know-how.
He's a boot knife guy.
He knows you run towards a knife. You run from a gun.
But yeah, the Jacob settling in right there on my lap was...
His butt flap?
Genuinely off-putting.
Mm.
Yeah. You didn't like it. It wasn't your thing. Guess what?
I thought I'd be able to handle
test,
it.
You're not gay.
True.
Dude, cool. You
maybe I didn't like that I was getting turned on.
Yeah, you passed my gay. Why'd you get so emotional about it?
Maybe I didn't like
you
how
failed
fucking
my gay
hot
test.
It was, dude.
No, man, I'm not gay, okay? This is just what guys do.
It's what guys do.
Santa Claus, little Jacob will do anything for you.
And we do mean anything. We found him at a bus stop.
Anything.
Oh, Santa Claus and little Jacob, everyone. We're going to take our last break.
Yeah. Wait a second, Dan. Wait a second.
Is what?
Were we being too loud? Did we wake up little Jacob?
Jacob, we thought you were asleep.
Santa, is that you?
Yes, how are you? Sorry.
Oh, man, this is kind of awkward.
I'm mad. Hey, shut up.
Were those the dogs? Was that Mrs.
Yes.
Santa Claus?
That's Santa's helper's girlfriend making noise.
Hey, I don't know if you see that hand gesture Jacob's giving, but he's going to break your fucking back if you keep talking shit, Shane. That's what he was telling me right there. Show him again, Jacob.
Damn.
Oh, you want some of that? Come get Jacob. Some.
Is that what you're going to do to my penis?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Sexual.
You're going to twist it.
I'm not going to lie. When I come back, I
haven't seen Jacob in a while.
Look at
I might subscribe to Jacob's OnlyFans. Jacob,
you know
do you have an OnlyFans?
Yeah. You know what he does? He reads cooking recipes shirtless.
He should have an OnlyFans. I bet, Jacob, you'd make a killing on an OnlyFans if you just did some nice topless stuff. Maybe work out with those straps
Jacob.
And like short shorts.
There's a blizzard coming. Why don't you bring over a sleeping bag, snuggle up with old Shane, Come on over. We can sleep together. Oh, you can stay in my little igloo. You and me. What do you think? We can watch movies, hot cocoa, mutual sexual petting at some point.
Hey, Shayna Claus, I don't want to be a guy that I don't want to be a guy that calls you out for something, but isn't it when you guys were in the room, the energy changed when Jacob locked in on you, and then you didn't want to be a part of it anymore?
Yeah, yeah. Last year? Yeah. Last year, I hated that bit, dude. That was gross.
You froze like a deer.
Yeah, well, it was you, Siddle. I felt your fucking the heat from your genitals on my lap, dude. It was disgusting.
Shane, he said he could feel, Shane, he said he could feel you growing. Fucking he could feel you growing.
Yeah, yeah. No, I didn't move. Grow.
Not to move under those Santa pants.
Shayna, do you like my teddy?
All right, we're doing other stuff now.
No, Shayna, little Jacob woke up for this.
Where'd you get this? Where'd you get it? I'm not doing the bit anymore. Where did you, a grown man, go out and buy his fucking dumb outfit and teddy bear?
Shayna Claus!
Come on, this is
Shayna! It's Christmas time!
It's not little Jacob. Yeah. This is Jake. This is Jake.
The guy directly across from my apartment burned his apartment to the ground.
He burned it down.
Yeah, his apartment across from mine is toast.
Were you scared?
I wasn't in at the time, but I got a call from the super saying because the fire department had to broke all the doors on my floor.
Jesus Christ, Jacob.
On my door to get in and out.
I wish you were there. It would have been...
Oh! Hey, guys. Hey, calm down. I'm not a fire.
Dude, if they would have brought Jacob outside, if they would have brought out Jacob wrapped in a blanket and holding him like a baby.
like 10 down a ladder. Outside.
Jacob's ladder.
Jacob's ladder.
How often would you say you masturbate, and what were the odds that a firefighter could break in your door and then catch you and then start making love to you?
Oh, why? Do you think that's the route it would go, is right into lovemaking?
I'd been so embarrassed. Because, yeah, I mean, I will. My apartment, I would daytime jerk because, you know, like on a weekend.
Jesus.
No, I agree with you. I think daytime's the time to jerk.
Jacob, absolutely. Everyone knows you jerk God and you Almighty, go see movies in the daytime.
If they bust down your my like my bedroom window while I'm in the being romantic with myself, that's embarrassing.
I knew you were gonna say gay. I knew you were gonna say jerking off weird.
Jacob, I think Jacob would immediately go to cover up and just immediately thank them for their service. He'd be like, "Thank you for all you do." He goes, "Thank you for what you do. Yeah. Thank you for your bravery."
You know, celery juice works.
You've been trying. You've been
Jacob,
doing
have you used the celery juice? Have you been seeing a woman? Have you been physical with a woman? Or are you just enhancing your own masturbates?
You got nothing to do during the
so have you been taking celery juice to just jizz harder by yourself?
Shane, do not come down on Jacob's quarantine science.
I like it.
We like him experimenting. We like him finding out about himself.
Keeps him busy. Stays busy.
You fuck. That's so crazy, dude. That's no, so funny.
I had to slow down. I'm at my parents' house, so I feel kind of bad.
You're at your parents' house, like drinking celery juice in front of your parents. Like, why are you drinking that? You're like,
nothing. I have experiments in my room. Goodbye. I'm doing experiments, mom and dad. Stop.
You'll see on laundry day, ma.
Yeah. Well, if Dad ever wants to Tilex the shower, he'll see what I've been doing.
Yeah. What? You've never talked to a child's never pled to you for presents?
Look, come on. The innocence of a child can't melt your cold heart.
The innocence of a child in a soft salt and pepper beard doesn't.
Also, some soft ass PJs.
Oh, yeah. Those are definitely going home with them.
PJs are nice.
Are you wondering if there's a flap in the ass?
There is.
There is a flap?
Yeah.
It's Velcro, too.
Do you want to see Shayna Claus?
We knew Shayna would get there.
Oh, there's a camera. No.
Get in there.
More negative press.
Hey, Jacob.
We're in it for each other. I'm excited for Joey Logano, but he didn't win. But tomorrow, Jacob gets to meet Kyle Busch.
I'm interviewing Kyle Busch tomorrow.
It's big for the bonfire.
Yo, yeah. Go kiss your kid on the mouth, you weirdo.
Kyle.
Jacob, when you say him, you go, it's nice to meet you, Kyle Busch, and then do like a butthead laugh and go, he said Bush.
You should do that. And then if he goes for the handshake, go the too slow. I thought you were fast.
Dude, how cool him, dude. He's a NASCAR guy. What the fuck's he going to do?
You're lucky you're interviewing him by himself, because we'd make you go in now with a leather jacket with the collar up and out cool Kyle Busch. You drive fast?
I'd ask if you want to go out and try to get laid later with me, but your cousins aren't in town. Boo yeah.
That, I'm running on pure diesel. Oh, are you unleaded or bitch made? Too slow.
Who's his big sponsor?
M&M's.
Ugh.
Bringing a big old bag. Let him know that
all,
I do. Let him know I do.
M&M's.
I'm telling you, come in and eating Reese's Pieces, or you're a pussy.
Wait, what is Reese's Pieces under the banner of M&M's? Or
better not be.
Are they under the Mars? Any of the M&M's? Companies?
Why would they make peanut butter M&M's?
What candy gang are they in? Are they in fucking?
One of them's Mars, dude.
What set they rep?
I think I thought it was Mars. M&M's.
Yeah, M&M's is Mars, but is Reese's Mars? I think Reese's is Hershey.
If it's not, dude, I want you to eat Reese's Pieces and it's fucking fine. I mean, like, they're like E.T., dude. Go at them.
I don't know if he can be around Reese's.
Hmm?
I don't know if he can be around competitor candy.
That's what I'm saying.
You think he can't be in a room with it? He's going to fuck a peanut hell.
Yeah, I mean, you
he goes, hold on, is that Hershey candy? Dude, I'm going to fucking, you understand. I have a pen.
I'm closing up. I got a lot of press to do. Oh, God.
You can't be in the room with other sponsors? Is that Pennzoil?
I'm a Quaker steak guy.
I'm fucking, I can't fucking breathe. Get my EpiPen.
Oh, motherfucker. You made Black Lugo get the belts.
I told you I was going to get it.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I'm getting your coffee. It evens out.
Put the
just for the record, when you were gone, Jacob called you Kunta. I hit him.
Yeah, it's not cool, dude.
I hit him right in the mouth.
It's not the way champions act. That's why Jacob doesn't get to wear the belt.
You don't do the work, you don't wear the belt.
Yeah, sorry. We're just the fucking tag team champions of Sirius. Bad boys.
We're letting all other two-person broadcast teams know the champs are here.
The champs are here.
Now, a lot of you are going to say, did you guys purchase those belts yourself? And we're going to have to go, yeah.
Absolutely.
There's a paper trail.
Off eBay?
There's a paper trail.
And I'm pretty sure the guy that sold them to me is in a country that America's not friends with. But the point fucking remains that the champions do what they do to get shit done.
If you breathe on the front of this belt, Jacob, you see the fingerprints of Chinese children.
Yeah. Look, one of them scratched in help with one of their unformed fingernails.
They don't feed us. Get help.
Yeah. What's pretty cool is if you remove one of the plates, there's a letter. Dear Mr. Champion.
I assume you are a champion to have this belt.
You are.
Somebody with some real influence.
Yeah. My 14-year-old boss.
Even really busted my chops.
Are you excited to meet him? Even though he's the enemy of your favorite racer?
Yeah, I don't really hate the other drivers, but I'm
you say that now, cause
big
you know.
Joey Logano fan.
Dude, an enemy of your boyfriend is your enemy, dude.
What? Yeah, exactly. You need to know your
but
political
Kyle's
science.
Kyle's one of the greatest drivers in the history of the sport.
Don't you're treat him like that. Straighten his ass out. He's tired of getting treated like a princess, dude.
You know what? He's right. Be a bad boy.
Straighten his shit out, dude.
Go in and just let him know that you're a Joey Logano guy. Fuck everything else.
He's going to learn.
Dude, what's it like having champagne thrown at you by a bunch of cousin fuckers in the audience? Yeah.
Hey, do you drink milk after your races? Even though milk is delicious with dinner, it's stupid after races.
Hold up one of those pictures of hairy women and be like, what's wrong with this?
Yeah.
Nothing, right?
I don't want to see those again.
Come on, dude. You
ask him if he learned how to race by smuggling bootleg booze in the South.
You fucking hillbilly.
Yeah, ask him if he's a fucking moonshine.
And then start just counting like in the middle
Kyle's
of a count.
From
Las do like
Vegas.
To start counting in the middle of a count. Be
whoa,
like,
is Kyle Busch me?
Oh, yeah, he is.
Oh.
Look at that. You and Danny Hawk had a kid.
Hey, that's pretty cool.
Who knew? Man, I'll tell you what, that guy, his head is a perfect oval. I can't say. He looks like Mr. Poopy Pants from Rick and Morty.
He does. It's perfect oval.
I've never seen the most symmetrical head in my life. It's a fucking... His head is shaped exactly... Christine, can you overlay a zero from like a jersey?
Yeah, that's perfect. Like an Eagles jersey zero. Go to...
I don't know if I'll be able... I can try to do it, but... Okay.
Can't overlay it, but I mean, put it next to it.
Do you think his birth, he just slid out?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. He came out like an envelope.
Yeah, he was like, whoa, 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 whoa. The doctor was like, she's like, here he comes. He's like,
yeah,
just that
dude.
Perfect oval head.
It's like queefing out a fucking double-sided dildo.
Yeah.
What's that? Is that a Nuva ring?
No, it's an oval.
I didn't want a perfect oval. I wanted a zero from a jersey.
Oh, sorry.
Very specific. You can bring up any jersey.
God.
I said it so many times. Do you think how you interviewed Joey Logano last year when he won?
Yeah.
Way more nerve-wracking than interviewing his enemy.
Yeah, I think so. I'm on my own tomorrow.
I know.
So I'm a little nervous.
I'm filming Billions and Jay's is rocking ass.
Here's what I want your first question to be. Nice tight jacket, asshole. Where'd you get it?
Did you find
why are we not doing this on the show, helping you punch this up?
Did you find that jacket in the pussy section? He goes, excuse me?
Fucking pussy.
Whoa! Hard in the paint.
It's nice. Because, what are you wearing, your fucking daughter's jacket?
Oh, that's pretty cool. Did you steal that?
Look at the jerk off. I didn't see the money in the pocket.
Yeah, I just...
What an asshole. All right. Let's help you punch these up. Jacob's first question was going to be...
Well, the first ones are...
Jay, that is pretty good.
I'm going into defense mode.
Yeah, dude. I mean, I nailed it.
Nailed it.
Come on. The middle.
It's perfect.
Jacob, ask him what it's like to have the head the shape of a jersey zero.
He goes, excuse me? He goes, what did you say?
I said... And by the way, if he says, what did you say? I want you to come back with it firmer and extra dictionary.
Your head is shaped like a zero.
Yeah.
On a jersey.
But, you know, you won, I guess.
Hey, green light, answer the question, you moron.
Is he married?
Yeah, to Samantha Bush.
Let's see her.
You act like I know. Who's Samantha Bush?
Kyle.
You said it like I know. I know. You might as well have said Mrs. Bush.
Who's he married
to? Mrs. Bush.
Well, she has a name.
Okay. Well, I respect that, but you said it like I know who she is.
Let's see. That's the only picture?
It must be beautiful.
Oh, absolutely. What's going on? Does he dunk his kid in the cup? Does he waterboard his kid? Look at them. Oh, this is fun. Oh, what a fun family.
Yeah, it is weird because they eventually fucked in that cup.
Yeah.
It's weird to have the kid there.
Yeah, that is pretty weird.
Like, let's bring the kid out first before we ruin this thing.
Yeah, let's get all the clean pics out.
I'll tell you what, I don't care if he won everything. You can't take your father seriously dressed like that.
No way.
There's not a chance.
He looks like he's going to take Curious George from the jungle.
There is. What the hell's across his chest? Gak?
Yeah. Goblin jism. It's a silly string.
Oh, they're squirting him a silly string. Look at his kid. Yeah, his wife's pretty hot. I can't really see it. That's the only thing?
No, it was the first thing.
Oh, shit.
Those ass cheeks.
All right.
Come on, Jacob.
That's someone's mom, dude. Be a little respectful.
It's somebody's mother, bro.
That lady's a mother. She brought the gift of life into this world, and you're just over here fucking making her meat. What's up with the dog?
Can we go to the good boy
over to the right? What's going on with him?
You think she loves him, or every week she's just praying
Who's
for
that?
This guy to go All cartwheeling right. into the stands?
Do they have feral dogs? What's up with
Ew,
this guy?
What the fuck is that? We have a mange dog ranch.
He goes, keeps everything hot, knowing that this dog's bringing in diseases.
Hell yeah.
All right.
Yeah, she's good. How long have they been together for, Jacob? Do you know that?
It's been a few years. Okay. 5-6 years, I think.
You really know your stuff, dude. I feel like you're going in this interview with some knowledge.
Yeah, he and his brother from Las Vegas.
Ooh. Dude, you know what let's do?
Son is Brexton.
Ask extremely prodding personal questions. Like, what's your kid into?
Yeah. Or you could be like, stuff. Do you ever have a fear that maybe you're not chasing the right dream?
Where's your kid go to school at?
Oh, yeah. Does your kid have fears?
What is the personality of the hooker?
That's your wife is beautiful. You have a beautiful family. Do you worry that while you're on the road, someone's going to come just do something terrible to them?
What home security system do you have? Excuse me? What did you say?
Are you one of those same password for everything guys?
Are you ADT or Blink? Like, is it a camera or is it a whole thing?
He goes, actually, it's just one of those stakes I put on the lawn. There's nothing.
Total scarecrow.
Total scarecrow.
I just don't want to pay the monthly fee.
Mr. Booby Pants.
Mr. Booby Pants. It looks exactly like Mr. Booby Pants.
Jacob, hand him a hat, put it on, and then take a picture of him, a Polaroid, and then start laughing. And when he goes, what? Just say nothing. And then move on to the next question. Nothing.
Dude, if you had a tiny top hat, you could put it on and then take the picture.
Could you put this on,
please? Mr. Bush.
Am I putting this on?
And then he puts it on, and he goes... All right, thank you.
That head is thin and oblong, man.
It's the opposite of mine.
He has eyes like a, I bet he has eyes like a fish.
Mm-hmm.
It's one on each side, yeah?
Yeah, Christine, get one without the glasses.
Please.
Dude, all wonky-eyed. It's all crazy. Oh my God, he's got piranha face.
I feel like his eyes are going to be too far apart where it's like his brain takes it in as two different thoughts.
Yeah.
Like, he goes, man, he goes, I am married to two hot chicks.
Yeah. Look at this.
Well, me, I have two beautiful sons.
I drive two cars to work.
I drive two cars to work every day.
I get in my two Mercedes Benzes, and I drive to work every day.
Hey, oh, wow. God, my Zeus. God. He looks like a guy who didn't get a lot of airtime in Jackass.
Yeah.
He probably wasn't. He goes, I'm Kyle Busch, and this is...
He goes, I'm Kyle Busch, and this is Driving Drunk. Welcome to Jackass.
This is Wheelbarrow of Big Hill.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Kyle Busch, and this is Running Over Your Neighbor's Lawn.
He's going to be fun.
Oh, he's a Broncos fan.
Oh, here you go.
Tough loss. Sorry, everyone in the Mile High.
Kyle Busch, exactly how many too many teeth do you have?
How many teeth could you lose?
Yeah, how many extra teeth do you have?
Yeah. Do you have rows of teeth?
Do you ever consider, if you win a third championship, getting a few of them removed?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you like having the mouth of a Sigourney Weaver's alien?
If, ask him, if you punch him directly in the middle of the face, does he get, does it, he doesn't get one black eye?
Yeah.
If you hit him directly between the eyes.
Well, I couldn't win the fight. There was four fists coming at me at once.
Yeah. What's it like being bug-faced?
Don't ask that.
Don't ask that.
That's the only one that we've said so far.
This guy's a champion. Listen.
That's the only one we've said so far that I said you shouldn't ask.
I'm impressed with your knowledge about him. This guy's a fucking NASCAR champion.
You're only, this is a question. You're only 34 years old now. How many more championships do you think you have in you?
That's kind of a weird Jewish mom question.
No, I like it.
Why don't you win more championships?
That's why I wanted to eat her.
Why do you only have a couple championships? Your brother Kurt has... does he have any?
His brother Kurt did win one.
Just one? Are they tied?
Usually you're only 34.
How many does Kyle have?
Kyle just... Yeah, Sunday won his second championship.
It's going to be... Is it going to be weird?
How many did Kurt win?
He's got a lot more wins.
Kurt's got one, Kyle's got two. Is that going to be weird for Thanksgiving? That's a question I'd like to know. What's it like having a brother whose eyes are closer to each other?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Is that hard?
This motherfucker's got rosacea.
Hey, what's it like having Santa Claus cheeks on your brother?
Fucking have somebody come in and throw the green makeup on. Take that shine down, bro.
Jesus Christ.
Even I know that.
He looks like he just had fucking four beers at lunch.
What happened, dude?
He's got DUI face.
Where's his trial track on the sun?
Yeah, he goes, guys, turns out I'm an SPF 100 guy. I can get, you know, you can get sunburned through those little visors.
Thank God for the internet, because it is rare.
Yeah.
SPF 100.
Yeah, I got to get it shipped in from you.
Damn, everything on that guy's fucking face was red.
Not every guy can look like Joey Logano.
No, that's fair enough.
You know what? I'll give you that.
You should. Can you say, like, sure, Kurt has more championships, but look at his face.
Yeah.
You should say that.
Hey,
he looks like White Seal.
Or you know what you should do? You should go, hey, why does your brother got sunburned face? Just say it like that.
And then he'll be like, what do you mean? And just move on to the next question. I always like just bailing. Yeah. Give him one chance to answer everything, and then if he doesn't answer, move on.
You know what? He's right.
He goes,
revolving door questions.
Yeah. Are you worried about your wife becoming a pig eventually and having the dumper? I'm like, excuse me?
There you go. Last year at Talladega, you came in third. Then hit him with a race question. Is Talladega probably your most difficult...
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd probably say, cool. You think your son's going to take after you or your whore wife? What?
Excuse me?
He goes, dental floss. What? Do you use it every day?
Yay or nay?
What do you think of impeachment?
What? Oh, man. Let's take our first break.
Really?
Is it
already that time?
It's already that time. Let's take our first break and we'll come back.
Sorry,
I want to talk with...
Fucking glue around my waist.
We have a fun person in the studio today we'll talk to when we come back.
Yeah.
We have Joe... list and
Mark maybe Norman. Mark Norman.
He's trying.
Yeah, it's a flight issue, so we'll see.
What's his flight? Ask for his exact flight number.
I'll be honest. I'm the type of friend that would tell him. I would text him. Don't even sort of concern yourself with it, and just go home and get your shit together before I have somebody race from the airport
tell him
to come here.
If he's not gonna make it, tell him to just go home.
Because God forbid he gets here like with his like 15 minutes left, I feel terrible for him running in for that.
Yeah, and then we can have a chair for List and our guest.
Mrs. King.
Jacob's pissing off fucking Kyle Busch tomorrow.
Jacob, If people that work here don't have to get between the two of you, I think it's a failure.
Also, Jacob, stand, if he comes at you, stand right in the middle.
Yeah.
And then he'll fucking lose you in a second.
He's going to be thrown off by the fact that Black Lou's going to be there, because that's like, I mean, it's like a unicorn, dude. He sees three a year.
Yeah. He's going to go, oh, I'm sorry, is this the NBA channel? I was trying to find a conversation for radio.
It's like seeing snow in Atlanta, man. Yeah. A couple of dustings a year.
Kind of happens. Everyone gets excited because they know it's a rarity.
So he's going to be off kilter anyway, and he's not going to do anything crazy with Black Lou standing there.
Yeah.
He thinks he's a goddamn animal. He's terrified of Black Lou.
Listen, dude.
Do you think he's going to listen to this show?
Probably.
God, I hope not. That's going to be weird for you.
It is.
I'm going to have a cookie.
Have a cookie. We'll take our break. We'll be right back. It's the bonfire. Yeah. So Jacob, last week,
yeah,
a time that we weren't able to come in,
yeah,
had an opportunity to interview. Jacob's a big NASCAR fan.
Oh, hell yeah.
Huge. Are you a NASCAR fan?
I've been to one.
So you enjoy it?
Uh-huh.
Kyle Busch won the championship.
Fuck yeah, I've been rooting for him.
Yeah, yeah, no, he's been your guy. He's always been your guy.
Are you a fan of his eyes being so far apart?
Yeah, see, he sees the road that way. He's got peripheral yeah. vision.
I didn't even think of that, Ari.
He doesn't even know what's in front of him. Oh, there's my nothing. God. There's yeah. nobody in front of him because he's got the eyes on the side.
Try to sideswipe Kyle Busch.
Good luck.
It ain't going to happen. He's going to see you before you think it.
Better start planning that bitch early.
Yeah. With those peripheries, he's actually allowed to talk on his cell phone while he drives.
With his hands.
Yeah.
He's older with his hands.
Cop goes, do you know why I pulled you over? He goes, I saw you coming before you even knew you were pulled over.
Full hands. No, so Jacob got to interview him, Kyle Busch.
Yeah.
And
well, this was also put on me like the night before.
Very true. It was brought on to him. Jacob.
What do you mean? They just sprung it on you?
Yeah.
They like Kyle Busch come from behind?
Yeah. Right. Kyle Busch was like, I'm going
to
talk to you.
They know around here I'm a NASCAR fan, and they wanted somebody who knew NASCAR.
Because you guys are like, how?
Well, we weren't even coming. We weren't even going to be here.
They weren't here.
Oh.
We knew that, but Jacob, we said, you should still do it, Jacob, and interview him. Like, get an interview with him. He goes, okay. He wrote down a couple questions.
He said, since you pussies won't do it, I'll do it. That was pretty aggressive.
Can I make a suggestion? Or not a prediction?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Was he excellent in the interview?
Well, here's the thing.
We haven't heard it.
Funny you should ask. I don't know the answer to that. What I know is when we came in after he did it, Black Lou said he did a great job. Jacob said he didn't like it. Jacob told me one or two things that were said that I understand what his woes are, his concerns. But we're talking about doing good radio. That was that was us hitting the dog with a hanger.
Yeah. We're just teaching you a
piece of rebar.
It's a sawed off piece of rebar.
Just dinged it with a piece of rebar because I'm saying, don't fucking touch me. Don't fucking touch
go
me.
Go by man. The simple one. He likes dogs.
Yeah, go by Doof over there. Hey.
So we did this interview.
The interview, went fine up until the end. See, the one thing is,
so you called him a
faggot? Didn't know.
Yeah.
He hates the Hard driver team. I root for more than anyone.
Who do you root for?
Joey Logano.
Joey Logano.
Oh, shit. You don't know about that beef?
No.
And there is so actually a beef. There's actually a beef.
Yeah. No, I mean, they've fought on really, that.
I know you were guessing on that, so I want to let you know you nailed it. There's a beef.
What's the beef over?
Fucking car racing. Car, yeah. Shit, dude. I don't know.
Like,
you think motor oil.
Valvoline?
You think Family Guy's saying. Better than American Dad? You fucking idiot.
Whoever uses whatever motor oil and fucking window cleaner they use.
Yeah.
What are the people like that fighting about?
One of them says Monster Energy isn't the most effective energy drink.
One of them says that fucking Big O tires isn't as good as fucking...
Yeah, NOS.
I'm not going to come off good at the end because I didn't defend myself or my driver because I just... First of all, I love Kyle. Even though I didn't know he was my driver's arch nemesis, but
wow.
He's still one of the top... Maybe 10 drivers of all time.
With that eye spacing, dude. Of course he is.
And
oh,
so yeah, they get into
they get
it.
Fight.
Oh, whoa, dude.
That's
like
Logano and him in a fight,
dude. Yeah. I like Kyle. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Dude, Kyle walks up and fucking right up to does him. The like, thing, I'm
punch you. Dude. Your this guys are a bitch, years. Jacob.
No, you guys are. Joey hits back.
No, he doesn't.
No, this one. This I don't guy think he knows what's
dude,
coming.
He marched over to
he
him.
He knows what's coming. Yeah. He's staring at him. He's coming.
He didn't believe it was
going to
happen.
I love the punch. The not going face to face, just straight punch.
No, Joey will fight.
Who punched who first? Who punched
Kyle? Kyle Busch fucking threw the punch.
It doesn't
first.
Look like a fight. It looks like he punched in the face and lets him be and let people pull him away.
What's that over? Wow, he sees us from the side.
You don't give a fuck about the cops, dude. He can't see the cop. It's too in front of him. He's too centered.
Man, that was a few years back. Also,
what was that over? I mean, no, it was Las Vegas.
I think. Joey wrecked him in this one.
Oh, or might have wrecked him. So I don't know, dude.
And then he won.
I think I'm turning into a Kyle Busch fan.
You'd see, I want to get Kyle on the show because I think you guys would actually love him. I think he'd be a great interview.
I'll jump him for what he did to you.
I've seen so much of, like, you run somebody, like, you motherfucker, and then it's all like, well, go, bring it. And this guy didn't do any of that. He just walked, I punched.
Yeah, dude, he walked up and was just like, I'll fucking kill you.
This was before I started watching NASCAR, so I don't remember.
You would have picked Kyle Busch as your guy then.
No, I mean, I love Joey, man.
The way he takes a punch?
You just got into NASCAR, like, in the last 2 years?
No, old was this?
That was 2017.
Oh, no, then maybe I just don't remember it.
You know, yeah, but you don't remember it because your fucking hero got punched in the face by a fucking hillbilly.
Your boy got bitched out by a fish eyes.
Watching, like,
a fucking half Chinese girl you like.
Yeah.
He actually started following because he was watching Chick My Ride and it was Nas in your car. Yeah. He thought it was Nas' car.
Got that Nas.
He goes, ha, 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 I got my boy Kyle Busch here to beat the shit out of you.
Yo, it's the exhibit. Yo, we about to put a ceiling fan in this Datsun.
I got a forced central cooling into this Civic.
I got a 400 disc change in right underneath the passenger seat.
I turned the trunk into a waterbed. Did you see that fight again?
It's such a great punch.
What am I saying? There was bunk beds in the back seat of your truck.
Give me do the thing where he's like, what if I told you I strapped a half a kilo of cocaine under the car? What? He goes, Bye. You better get going.
Let's see if you snitch.
I put the spirit of a shaman into the trunk.
And then that guy's in a fucking waiting room at the police station. Exhibit comes. He goes, I had to make sure you was legit.
welcome to La Familia.
You didn't talk good.
You get to meet El Chapo.
Now, anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah. I'm going to put a 3-tier chandelier in your Volvo.
I was unprepared. This was my very first interview
You did prepare. You prepared. I'm not saying it's an insult. You did prepare. You prepared well.
I didn't know about him not liking Joey. That was the big problem. And then
I want to hear that play out. I want to hear that play out in real time. Where you can
I'm not a comic.
Like,
so anyone I didn't I'm have a fan a comeback. Of, you fuck. Guys.
Anyone I'm a fan of, I YouTube the words that person fight. To make sure I find out who my enemies are now.
Yep. enemies, my friend or my enemies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Enemies of my enemies, my friend.
Yeah. Friends of my friends.
Are my friends.
Okay. I don't know
that's what this is.
Friends of my enemies.
My friend is my enemy. That's the original statement. You could play it any number of ways, though.
Enemy of my enemy is my friend.
Friend of my enemy is my enemy.
What if you're friends with some of your enemies, but then unlike, they used to be friends, but now they've kind of drifted
what
apart.
What if, like,
frenemies, dude?
What if, like, oh, what if the friends of my frenemies are, like, kind of chill?
So you and Kyle Busch are frenemies.
Yeah, you guys are frenemies. Oh, you should have said that. You should have said that mid-interview, Jacob. You should have gone, oh, no, are we frenemies?
This sucks that we're frenemies now. But.
Yeah, Kyle Busch
does. Yeah, but great. At the end of your spine, cool guy. Hey, Kyle Busch, very cool. Black Lou, friend-zoned. Jeez Louise.
Did you walk out? Up your jacket and say, I have a selection of paints if you want to trade some.
Yeah.
You should have punched him in the fucking face. You should have been like, by the way, I'm a Joey Logano fan, and then just lunged at him and had Black Lou hold you back the whole time.
He turned as soon as he found out.
Did he?
Did he really?
Because in the beginning, I said I'm a NASCAR fan. He immediately said, who's your driver?
Oh, dude, let's listen to this interview.
Kyle likes to scrap, and I didn't scrap because I wasn't ready.
Who's your driver? I would think, and probably you would think too, is like, oh, cool, you're a NASCAR fan, would be his answer. Not like, what side are you on?
He wants to know because he despises Joey Logano, which I didn't know at the time.
If I were you, my answer would have been Tiger Woods.
You can scroll.
Who's your favorite driver? And I go, Ryan Gosling.
You can fast.
What, bitch? Your favorite driver? Anyone but you.
Yeah. I go, Burt Reynolds, Smokey and the Bandit.
I was going to do Burt Young from Back to School.
Yeah, I go, Richard Petty Jr. and your mom's pussy. What?
Jerry Reed. Pretty Mary Sunshine.
That orangutan who drives the car in the front.
Any which way but loose.
Yeah.
Yeah, Clive the fucking orangutan.
Why is Christine, by the way, dressed like she's ready for a fucking interview?
Right? It's Christine from Remax. She took her headshot today for her bus advertisement.
That's why I don't wear clothes like
she
this.
Goes, this way, I sit at home.
I bought this shirt like 5 months ago. I put it on. And
she walks out with a blazer and that on today, and I go, you look really nice. First thing I said, you look really
smart
nice.
Outfit.
And then, of first course, minute. Immediately I started saying, you know, I got a phone call from someone else who would have enjoyed me saying, Christine's all dressed up like a Remax. She's going to take her headshots today for her bus advertisement. Yeah, sure. And she goes in the other room and goes, this is why I don't fucking try to wear news. I'm like, oh my Lord. I said, you look good immediately.
It's just the problem is we're like, used up all the insults for your usual outfit.
Yeah. So
it's just like, well, this is actually better, but we're just new.
This is new territory.
Yeah. We think your other clothes are hilarious. We just hit all those jokes already. What's up, Bandit? What are you doing? Oh, that is a pile of shit. Oh, that is a pile. Oh, that is a steaming pile.
Oh, something so big.
Oh, have you been eating Ari food? What's happening?
You go, oh, how can something so big come out of something so
big? Oh, my God. You have so much room in you. Where does it go?
Oh, my God.
Where's it coming from? It's like soft serve.
Where are you keeping that, huh?
I didn't mean to bring a pee pad and I forgot.
It's hilarious. Well, I mean,
if it's shit,
she didn't.
He
didn't.
Is it a he?
Shit.
What? No, dogs are boys.
It's a she.
What,
dude?
No, dogs are.
Dogs are always good boys.
Sniffing around, but has not shit.
It's when they do the circle walk, and you're like, oh no,
yeah, coming your way.
Oh, it's locked.
It's coming your way.
She's gotten a few of my neighbors. What's it called? Mats. Doormats.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and then just like you just cover it up and walk.
Of course. Yeah, because you try to pick that out and it just gets in. It's like bubble gum and hair.
It's mostly just pee.
You should pee over that piss. So
that's right. No. It was me. Yeah. Don't
I'm marking my territory. Don't let me see your wife or I'll hump her.
We have 20 minutes of show left. I couldn't guess how long it's going to take us to possibly get through 9 minutes of this.
You don't have to listen to all of it. You want to just. Let's not the beginning and then the last minute.
Let's not listen to the boring fucking NASCAR
Black
part.
Blue, would you say that most of this has something that audibly we would enjoy?
Personally, I think every question is a hit.
All right.
It's from Jacob, but...
Let's do it.
Say no more.
It's up to him.
Let's do it, dude. Oh, look at Bandit. What a good
guy. Kyle, welcome to the bonfire with Big J. Ogerson and
I
Dan
already
Soder.
Hate your attitude.
I like it. It's very professional.
God. I can't even listen to this, man. I hate hearing my recorded voice.
I know.
It's
the worst. Now imagine hearing it live.
Yeah, welcome to my life.
Jacob, the resident NASCAR fan. And congratulations, Kyle. 56 wins, and now your second NASCAR Cup championship, man. That's unbelievable stats, man, at 34 years old. And you made it to the comedy office, so has it sunk in?
A little bit, somewhat, yeah. It's certainly in the moment, you remember the first one and the excitement and just, being too excited yourself that you kind of forget about some of the moments that actually take place. And so this time around was just able to kind of have a more peripheral look to everything and see all of it. And of course my son as well too, he's 4.5 now. And so we had a chance to.
Right now it seems like he's like, you know what, Jacob, I think me and you are about to become best friends.
Yeah, man, I feel like I could kiss this guy and he wouldn't tell a soul. He'd
there's
just
only one thing.
Myself.
I'll go eat after this.
There's only one way this can go south.
Oh, man, there's only one name that he could say that would turn me against this nice man.
And what are the odds? New York City, anyone giving two shits about NASCAR enough to know the fuck driving. Joey Logano is.
And a Jew, no less.
Yeah. A Jew that knows cars? Well, I'll be shining.
I thought Joey Logano was the lead singer of Hoobastank until you told me about this beef right here.
And the reason
that's
is
that's how you got me
you.
In.
So... Let's hear it.
Yeah.
It's going
go for a ride around the track with me and to kind of see the championship a little bit from his perspective this time around.
By the way, pause for a second. That'd be great to have him going 240 miles an hour with a 4-year old car flipping and the little cute kid flipping around too.
You see him come out the window, like, oh, fuck.
Douse him with that.
I always give super fingers on the way down.
Bye.
Get it all in, man. To be two-time is pretty special.
Yeah. That's right. Brexton wasn't there on 2015.
Well, he was. He was only 6 months old. He could have fit in the cup. So
that was
pretty special, though.
You just called that his son's name?
Oh, wow, dude. Name.
That's weird.
It's weird.
That's weird.
I'd be like this.
That's
how do you
know? That's preparing.
I'd go like this. How do you
that's
know
not preparing. It's weird.
I go,
that's weird.
Come on.
That's weird.
Dude, if I was doing that, I'd go, how do you know my son's name?
Too personal.
How do you know my son's
that's
name?
That's personal. That's weird.
That's very personal.
How do you know my son's name? Jacob, how do you know my son's name?
Right there, I think it turned. I mean, he hasn't let it sunk in yet, this Bush guy, but like, it's sinking in.
This is what rattles him, is he's like, what are you trying to do in my life?
I bet as soon as you ask that question, he goes, your son, Braxton, blah, blah. I bet did you see him call for a guy? And he goes, come here. He goes, this guy does work here, right?
Yeah.
He's like, all right. That's weird.
I didn't think you were going to shit on that one.
I didn't shit on it. I'm just saying, that's an odd thing to do.
I completely missed that one when this I was thinking of how bad
if
this
I was being interviewed
go.
At radio and they asked me about... If they go, hey, I know you have a daughter. I know you have a daughter. I know blah, blah, blah. If a radio personality came to me and he goes, so was little Isabella around when you did that first thing? I'm like, what?
What? Did you research
I
your
I want to know how your mother, Terry, is.
Yeah. Does she still get off work at 7:30 in that dark parking lot?
Does she still giggle when she comes?
Yeah. Does Trish still take the D-121? And you're like, what's that? I'm sorry, what?
That's weird.
All right.
I know it was trying to be a Bond moment, but that was odd.
And did you look that up? I heard them say it. On NASCAR Race Hub, they say that to him.
It's just, it's weird. I'm not wrong. It's weird.
So you didn't look it up? You already knew that?
I did know it from years. I just know the guy, so I know his family. Yeah.
So without looking it up again, you were like confidently go, little Brex.
Brexit.
No, I'd argue, I'd go as far as say Jacob was excited to drop that hammer, so he maybe it's got to be like, this guy does know his shit.
Wait, his name is Brexit?
Yeah.
Wait, really? His name is Brexit?
Yeah.
No, I thought you meant Brexton.
Brexton, sorry.
Did you say Brexit?
No, I said Brexit.
Did you call his son? Did you call him Britain leaving?
Leaving the EU?
No.
He goes,
now you're just throwing me off.
Kyle Busch just goes, I don't believe in Brexit.
Yeah.
NASCAR races are notoriously against leaving the EU.
Yeah.
How much do you wish this audio was? He goes, now, was little Brexit around then? He goes, Brexton,
but I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, right.
Oh, come on.
What? That kid?
They've got hair in opposite places.
No, fuck that, dude. I'm not going to be nice to his kid. He was mean to our Jacob.
You'd like
it. Well, let's hear it. Kyle Busch is a scrapper. I respect the fuck out of him already.
I do, too. That's why I didn't know what was happening.
guy walks up and throws a punch.
It's great. I love that kind of attitude.
Kyle Busch up so fast, dude. It'd be unreal.
Kyle Busch would...
I'll be honest, I was about to make fun of Brexton. But I held back because I'm like, if I ever meet that guy, he's definitely just going to punch me.
Dude, he'll walking forward, just fucking ending you, hockey style.
I want to have one-piece outfit fights with him.
Nah, man.
Me and him in coveralls.
In mechanic suits. Yeah, just one piece of clothing.
Fucking astronauts who have had enough.
Oh, God damn it. If I rip this spacesuit off, I'll beat the shit out of
him. I got to tell you, Kyle Busch goes for it, dude. He goes in for the... a guy who's willing to fight that's a big first move.
Yeah, dude, you don't win two cups from nothing.
That's right. How many does Joey Logano have?
He won his first last year. You were there.
Like a lady boy. Got you.
Just
got
one.
You.
Just
let's play the rest of the interview.
You were in my home for that.
I know.
Jesus.
No one's going to remember how you reacted to that. No one's ever going to forget.
That's Jacob here. Joey Logano win.
You want to hear what happens when Joey Logano wins? Get you built up a little bit? Give it to him again.
Boy, that's Jacob?
That's real-time audio.
Yeah, it's real-time audio. Then he looked to the side. He looked to the side. He was like, what?
He was so happy.
Play that one more time for me.
That's usually that's the laugh you hear up the stairwell of a castle.
No, the dog is responding to Jacob.
You
do it again. It's barking. Bandits barking at Jacob.
Every the dog. I want to get him on mic.
Even she thinks it's uncool.
Yeah, she's like, Jesus, is this for a NASCAR race?
Gotta play it again. She's not going for it.
She's over it. She found out it was Jacob.
She's more of a Kyle Busch.
She's a Kyle Busch lady. So, all right, get back to the interview.
That was pretty special, though. With this time, he might be able to have a memory of this one, though.
And I remember people giving you.
I remember watching Brexit be born. He's like, excuse me? I was there. I was in the room.
I faked the name and got into the hospital.
I pretended to be a male nurse.
I broke my own arm so I'd have a reason to be there.
I was so happy to watch you become a father, Kyle. What?
Now, Black Lou, I have a question for you. Did you know that was crazy out of the gates and not tell him that?
No, I had no idea. That was a great catch.
Yeah, that's it.
It's not crazy. It happened. NASCAR, they always say they're all family people. So
they're family people, not your family. They're family people for their own family.
If you just said, here's the thing. Now, Kurt is his brother, right? Who's a racer. If you go, now, if you and Kurt had some sort of, I don't think that's weird at all.
Right.
Oh, yeah. This is calling his son by name, not saying your son, but just talking about him like you've hung with him. Like he goes, breakfast nice. I met him. He goes, I was at Chuck E. Cheese night. I just talked to him for a little. I didn't want to hurt him. I just wanted to look at him a little bit.
Why is it okay for the NASCAR reporters to do it and not me?
It's weird if they do it too.
All right, then we're all weird.
Yeah.
They all just say little Brexit.
Yes.
They wouldn't say your son. They wouldn't say your son.
They say Brexton.
That's stupid.
Fucking microphone fight.
That's an idiot.
Fuck you, Ari. Fuck you.
It's like an airplane.
It's killing Lou.
It's much.
Destroying DJ Lou.
It's
killing the audience. Really.
Sorry, guys. We're having a mic fight.
Get off me. Get off me. Then you get off me.
It's the interview's going great though. He's
enjoying
the interview
you.
For the last.
He didn't think it was weird
even
that you
fight,
asked.
Even that fight.
Let's
just disappointed in myself at the
Stop
end.
Stop it.
Okay, let's hear it.
You blew it.
A lot of slack, and man, I couldn't believe it because I thought that was more. That was incredibly impressive. Your first victory coming back from what I saw as one of the worst wrecks I've seen, man.
Yeah, 2015 when I wrecked at Daytona and broke my leg, broke my foot, opposite legs.
Well, way to bring up his worst moment.
Yeah. Do you remember when you caught your wife cheating on you?
What was worse than that? That or when your dad died in front of your face?
Remember when he fell into that buzzsaw?
I believe Brexton was in the room.
Yeah.
Brexton was screaming, and that's what made your father fall into the blade.
Born from blood, he shall die in blood.
Yeah. Was pretty gut-wrenching, you know, missed the first part of the season, but then was able to go through all the rehab and everything to be able to get back and be strong enough to go through the regular season and win four races in the regular season, make the playoffs, go through the playoffs, and to be able to win the championship in 2015 was really special. I mean, there was a lot of heartache that year. My son was born that year as well, too, just, you know, in May, right when I got back into the race car, it was his birth, and then this year, being able to win four races in the early part of the season and run really well and get some good points going. And then we kind of fell on a lull a little bit. You know, we didn't win for 20-something races.
Fucking pussy.
That is probably going to start the weird part.
Oh, my God. That sets a tone for sure.
Yo, dude.
Wow.
Man, you can't jazz up in description NASCAR if you're the guy who won it all.
Yeah.
The guy who reaped all the rewards can't make me feel like I give a shit about what happened to that.
It's so exciting.
to win at Homestead, so yeah. Felt good to bring home the hardware there at the end of the day. But both years seem to have a lot of similarities.
Yeah, but
can I rewind that 10 seconds? Do you say similarities?
I say words wrong all the time. I'm a big idiot.
A lot of similarities.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just got to throw a punch first.
Yeah.
I was thinking about that. I mean, and you had to be flawless Sunday. I mean, what happened to your teammates? And
mm-hmm. What's little Brexton going to wear with this award ceremony?
Is Brexton still afraid of clowns?
What?
If I what? May, I have some ideas what for an outfit. Say? What did you say? Can he be a sailor? I think he'd look really great in sailor stuff.
Oh, welcome. Jacob, do you ever want to swing at one of the people in the studio?
All the time. All the time. And he should.
They give you as much abuse as if you're wearing a fucking Remax salesman outfit.
Yeah. Christine, do you have a three-bedroom, two-and-a-half bath that I might be able to see? Probably in the Westchester area.
You see, this is why I get a thing and everybody gets.
Hey, if you don't sell enough houses, you call them Maxtard.
What happened to them? What does it say about your team under pressure?
Yeah, well, every team sometimes in those moments falter or have some issues or whatever, and we've done that as well too. Last year we weren't that great, and then the year before that we didn't make a smart enough pit call and actually got ourselves caught off strategy, and we weren't able to win in 17 either. So you do have to be perfect. You have to have execution, and you know, we had some of our miscues and mishaps and whatever through some of the playoff races, you know, speeding on pit road or having some issues on pit stops or whatever it might be that prevented us from winning races in the final 10 weeks of the season. But then
I feel like
we felt like
out.
We were cleaned up and ready to go by home.
All right, you sound like you look like you're zoning out.
How were you awake through this?
Can I? You could skip through the first
listen,
few minutes
are
NASCAR questions. I know you don't want
to. Yeah,
no,
I'm looking for the bill, too, but.
You want to get to the Dan questions?
No.
The ones that you reworked for me?
Guys,
yes.
Come on.
Then I would go to, like, 3 minutes towards the end.
Okay.
I mean, the NFL's the godfather right now, man. They got it all going on, so they're certainly really stout.
That's who you're going to take out?
Yeah.
NASCAR sells shitloads more tickets than NFL.
Barring crashes, what's the funniest or worst thing that's ever happened to you inside the
30
car?
30 seconds ahead.
Inside the car?
Playing.
Yeah. You guys are in Sorry about that.
Come on, you're doing great, dude. You gotta be. You're beating
I just
up.
Know you're zoning out with the NASCAR question.
I'm not zoning so out. Right it's just so boring and dumb. It's the only well, sport we're gonna into it. It's worthless.
No,
I'd rather listen to championship darts.
Darts are fun. Darts are fun. You know they can drink and smoke while they play.
180.
I love it. I love it. I love a good dart game.
Tournament's not terrible, you know, and there's a big wreck on lap 3, and there's a red flag, and we're sitting there for like 10 or 15 minutes, and it's just dwelling in my head, like, I got to go to the bathroom. I got to go to the bathroom. I need to get out. Like, I want to get out of the car and walk to the bathroom. But we're out on the racetrack. We're sitting on the front stretch of the racetrack, and so you can't just get out of your car, right? You know, so
he has to make a duty.
Having to hold it for the entire time, the rest of the 322 laps that were left. And it was about another 4 hours. And literally, I couldn't even get out of the car after the race was over. My guys had to drag me out of the car. And when I got out and stood up, I was like hunched over, bent over, walking to the bathroom. Just couldn't stand. It was so bad.
Oh.
I mean, that it might not be funny, but it was funny in the time because I was just funny. So young and dumb and didn't know that you had to go to the bathroom before a damn cup race.
Dude, that's just like, that piss must have felt like that was like Austin Powers. Evacuation.
Complete. I have a feeling the feeling would go away. He wasn't holding
it would go away.
He wasn't holding in a piss for 4 hours.
No, you're in the strapped in the car. You can't
I understand.
Get out.
I'm saying but he's like, not. It went away. His mind the whole time. It went away. That you feeling went away. He was able to will it away. At some
you're
point.
You're a badass if you can piss going like 230 miles an hour.
Or they right, or he pissed right down his leg. He's afraid to tell you because he doesn't want to be vulnerable in case he has to knock you the fuck out.
He's going to take care of one of his enemy's cronies.
I think it was metaphor. He really wanted to come the whole time.
Yeah, he's like, I just had a hard cock.
I was hunched over with desire.
Do you know what's like to be a question mark of passion?
I have an comprehensible need for speed.
Yeah, he goes, a sexual fetish of mine is going fast.
I'm insatiable.
My sexual appetite is insatiable.
Until I got that F1, I didn't know.
I'm a speedophile. The faster I go.
You're a crashophile like the movie from the 90s? You gotta crash cars and fuck?
Remember that movie? That's a movie?
The Crash.
Come on. Crash. You don't remember that movie?
They just like, she's like.
We've watched it on this show before. We've definitely looked this up before.
She just looks at
James Spader and then they just crash cars and fucking them?
No.
It's a sexual thing.
The chick's just in a garage and she's like taking her tit and rubbing against the car and some guy comes in and just fucks her and she just like keeps looking at the car. Some random dude comes in.
He's always got to have weird sex. That guy can't just have regular
Spader?
Sex.
Spader?
Spader?
Oh, yeah.
Spader
the
always has
videotape,
Spader
right?
sex.
That's a good point. Write that
It's always mind. Weird James Spader sex.
Wolf? Remember when he was Wolf and fucked Jack Nicholson's girlfriend?
Oh, yeah. In the movie Wolf.
Yeah. When he wolfed.
When he wolfed
always
out.
Weird sex with him.
Always weird with this guy. Even on the blacklist, he's got to get pissed on.
Fucking less than zero. Piss.
This is Crash. I don't remember this. I remember the Academy Award.
Well, we can't go
film.
Through all that. We have 5 minutes. I have to hear where it goes.
Yeah, we got to hear it.
It's coming up. It's one more question. Dan's question, and then...
All right, stop yelling at me.
Cup race.
Kyle, I would have gone in my wetsuit.
I tried, not
a fire suit to me.
Trust me.
I can't hold it anymore.
There's been other drivers out there. I won't name names, but they've had number two incidences in their suits and stuff before, you know?
He goes, I won't say names. That bitch-ass Joey Logano shits himself whenever I'm on his tail.
Oh, and that tight-ass suit rides right up his goddamn back.
He goes, every time I'm behind that pussy, he's just shitting in himself, and he knows I'm right behind him.
His fucking ugly girlfriend's going to wipe his back turd.
Yeah. I heard he pays her. He goes, can you stop?
I also didn't picture you turning on Joey like this either.
I mean, this is the equivalent, what you're about to do, is the equivalent of Jay going to radio, and then those people going like, oh, I know you're on radio now. It's I'm a big radio guy. And you're like, oh, who's your guy? And they go, Bob and Tom.
You go,
and they just stare at you.
Yeah. Like they know.
Yeah.
That's by the way, you are probably the person he spoke to here in New York for sure that had the most information. He was like, I'm talking to a guy who knows NASCAR right now. And then you just said, like, you know it. Because he assumes you would know. What he has to assume is that you brought up Joey Logano to get under his skin because it's so a notable thing.
Joey about as much as he dislikes anyone else that beats him regularly. But I know his
name. Oh, shit.
Shot fired from Jacob.
Let it be known, Kyle Busch.
Ooh, Logano camp after your ass.
You got verbally traded paint with.
Let's play the rest of this fucking crazy confrontation.
Way too built up there.
Wait till you guys see this conversation.
When did it get physical? You said really violent physical he got.
You promised us a bloodbath.
You said you'd take a cut if you had to.
Yeah.
Can we set this story to There Will Be Blood at the end when he beats him with the
I've abandoned my boy. You have a car. It drives around. My car goes faster than your car.
All right, Kyle. After the race Sunday, did your dad admit that he loves you more than your brother, Kurt?
He sure did not. No. He told me a big congratulations and that he loved me, but there was no admittance that I'm number one in his life.
All right, last question. This is my reveal. I'm a Joey Logano fan.
Oh, my God. No wonder.
What the hell? Walk out before we even began.
Jesus, you're half his height.
Ask you who's your guy. It wasn't even brought up.
You
brought up earlier.
Back up. He went right at Jacob's Achilles.
He went right at your height.
Yeah, I told you.
Yeah, I don't.
Listen.
No wonder.
I didn't
what
want you to
hell?
Walk out before we even began.
Jesus, you're half his height. How could you? No. I guess you look up to the guy, huh?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Wait, so you knew he had a beef? You said he didn't want him to walk out. You got knew goddamn well he had a beef.
He didn't like him, didn't hate him. I knew he wasn't crazy about him, but not
clap back at him. Dude, we had so
many
examples.
Why do you think Joey Logano had that fight scrub with his name? Look, because he got his ass whooped?
Don't go all comic like you. I know you two would have had 50,000 responses. Jacob, I'm not a comic.
He didn't say on the show. On the show, we gave you like 20 things to say. Jay had the perfect one. You should have been like, why does your face look like a jersey zero?
Oh, come on.
He called you short, dude. You should have said not too short to fucking headbutt you in the dick, queef. Yeah.
You should have gone, don't leave Brexton alone.
Yeah. Nice onesie outfit to win a sport in, you asshole.
Yeah. You got to drink from your cup,
I didn't have
sissy
any of this.
Bitch.
You're rattling these off the fire, top of your head tonight.
You're a fire retarded suit.
Hey, when did your sister teach you how to throw a punch?
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that was the video where you tried to make out with Joey and he pushed you away.
You know what?
Read it wrong.
You know what JL calls you in our text thread? He calls you soft serve because your fucking punch landed.
Easy.
Felt like getting hit with go-gurt.
That's the lob.
These would all be good lines you should have said.
Yeah. No, but you did was good. He called you short and you laughed and then he...
Oh, yeah. I complimented him after this.
Oh, you just did the, well, here's four tickets for things I didn't have to give you tickets for. You go, thank you so much, officer.
Yeah.
You're letting me go home and not get arrested?
No.
I wasn't proud of Jacob,
I thought you were very pleasant with him. Keep playing the rest of the interview.
Brought it up was like he asked you who's your guy, but that was not bore out in the interview that I just heard. He just said, I have an admission. I like your enemy.
Before this started.
Oh, 9 minutes earlier? And then you just skipped the 9 minutes to make your story fit whatever narrative you want?
No, but you said at the beginning, so you're saying at the beginning, who's your guy? Yeah, and you're like, we'll get to that?
Yeah, I purposely said I don't want to tell you now.
Got it.
Because you know he's your
guy. And then this is the heel turn.
I guess you look up to the guy, huh?
Exactly. But I like winners.
Okay.
So Kyle.
He's a dirty one.
I'm not hearing this.
Oh, shit. Yeah. He called your boy dirty.
Yeah, you can call him whatever he wants.
Oh, man. He went after your boy hard, dude. If I was doing an interview and someone was like, B.J. Okerson.
I'm trying to think of the equivalent. I feel like the equivalent if somebody's like, I like Kyle. He's like, oh, who's your guy? He's like, we'll talk about it later. And then they just name some horrible joke thief.
Yeah.
And you're like, all right, well, that's fucking, why? Why are you bringing that up?
You're sitting there like 20-year comics telling me how easy this would have been for you.
Well, let me tell you.
What you need to realize is you're a fan of the bad guy. He's a heel.
Yeah.
Logano, he's a heel, dude.
You know that song, I'm a Bad Guy?
Yeah.
By that Billy Eilish? That was written about Billy Logano.
You're a bad guy.
Billy Logano.
You cheat at racing.
Billy Logano.
Can we just turn this off here?
Stop it.
I don't even like to hear the end of this.
Stop it, Jacob. Jacob, seriously, you did a great job.
We're playing
Monday morning, but we're playing Monday morning quarterback with it because we can. Yeah. We can, of course, we can break down it. In the moment.
Yeah, and it's also very easy. You made horrible mistakes.
You made a great job. And he's being outwardly
aggressive.
I wish I would have
just come back at him like scrap because Kyle likes to scrap. He wants you to scrap with him.
You should have fucking punched him.
I just didn't hear
him.
I wasn't ready for the interview. I admit it.
Oh, well,
you should have gone. Yo, my boy's a bad boy.
Trading pain.
Oh, Joey Logano, dude. Somebody at home, I know you'll do it. Make us a montage video of Logano to this song.
Yeah. Oh, Jacob's bad boy.
You're a bad boy.
And maybe splice a little Jacob in there also. Yeah.
Oh. Thank you. Come on, let Kyle Busch know who he's fucked with.
Oh, I'm in awe of Kyle. You ever say he's like one of the best drivers ever?
So yeah, he throws a fucking.
And you're still kissing his ass. You can talk shit.
I am.
He'll never see you without. He'll never see you without me again, dude. And I swear to God, I will go low, and you can fucking.
I don't hate Kyle.
Well, he hates you.
Guess what? We're gonna.
I want to hear the end of this interview.
Yeah, please.
Kyle,
he's a dirty one.
Woo me.
Woo you?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm not a salesman. You got to figure it out on your own, and apparently you're not all that smart.
Larry, that's all I got.
I'm just kidding. Be a fan of whoever you want to be a fan of, man. It's
I'm
all good.
I'm a fan
good,
of NASCAR,
so.
And there I am go, a fan of yours, Kyle. Yeah. I think you're incredible, and you're one of the most exciting drivers, and I don't like vanilla.
Nah.
And you're not vanilla.
That's right.
And I love hearing your interviews.
I'm Rocky Road, baby.
Damn
yeah.
right.
Uh-huh.
I meant everything I said. You're a credit to the sport.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Good to see you.
He's like, I'm just done. Wrap it up.
Okay, I should have come back.
Dude, Jacob, you did fucking great.
You did good, dude. That was good.
You interviewed a fucking NASCAR champion, and you jokingly told him that you loved his enemy. It's great.
And he came around to you. He goes, I'm just kidding. You like whoever you like. It's fine.
Yeah.
He was cool at the end.
Come on, dude.
He's like, you're not worth it.
Yeah.
He called you short. He tried everything to pull some manhood out of you.
Yeah.
No, that worked on me. No, that hurt.
You went home and screamed in the mirror?
No, he was trying to get some scrap out of you. He was trying to pull it out of you. He wanted to see you oomph up, and you just giggled at his thing. But you did a good job. You didn't do bad. You could have some ball busts on him, but also,
as a first interview, I'm happy with myself.
You should be, and also that question was really that's a funny. I know Dan like put the thing, but woo me, like you delivered that well.
You did great. You did a great job on the interview.
He was yappy. He was a little yappy over your questions, so that's the only. It wasn't your fault, but you delivered it good.
You're a bad guy.
There it is. All right.
So Joey Logano, Ari Shaffir, he's gonna be taping a special in February.
Woo me.
And Jacob certainly did his thing on the live show. Do we have a little tease of what Jacob did on the show, Lou?
Sure.
This is Jacob hosting the Newlywed game that we did against Ron Bennington and Chris Stanley. Who knows who better? And this is Jacob's opening introduction of himself.
It's time to play How Well Do You Know Me?
Welcome to How Well Do You Know Me. I'm your host with the most, the Don of Dong, the Sultan of Twat.
Project, Jacob, project.
The lip ripper. The chiropractor, because I stay blowing out backs. Jacob, donkey, dick, batat.
Yeah!
Guy murdered. You hear the whole episode this
Stole
Thursday.
Stole the episode, for sure.
Well, we can't host this since we want to take on Mr. Bennington and Chris Stanley. So let's have...
We got to turn it over to, I mean, the host with the most, really. This is the man. This guy has all the pizzazz. Holding it down right now. Taking the reins. Jacob Batat, everybody. Your host.
Jacob Batat.
This is highly unusual.
I don't like this at all.
Welcome. Now it's time to play How Well Do You Know Me?
Welcome to How Well Do You Know Me? I'm your host with the most, the Don of Dong, the Sultan of Twat.
Project, Jacob, project.
The lip ripper. The chiropractor, because I stay blowing out backs. Backs, Jacob, donkey, dick, batat.
Let me just say this. This is a fucking fine right here. I'm ready to give up a point. That was so damn good.
This is a new bonfire game show created to kill time. I liked it better when it was called Bennington's Thanksgiving Show.
Oh, Jacob, jeez. It's not a stolen idea. Just bring it back.
Just another brainbuster idea from the two stone hacks I work for.
Jacob, where the fuck is this coming from?
That piece of paper.
I'm just reading my notes. Okay, you Austin cum dumpsters and the homos who use them as beers, ready to play?
Wow, Jacob.
It's a new Jacob. You're going heel on Austin?
Again, I'm just reading my notes. You know what they say about Austin. It's where Dallas goes to get their abortions.
Jesus!
You crunchy baby killers ready to start this motherfucker?
Yeah. They're still aborting you, Jacob.
You're like Stone Cold. You can't turn them. Yeah.
Let's introduce our contestants. First, the away team, comprised of a radio legend, good man, and expecting grandfather, Ron Bennington. Ron, can I just say, I hope you have a beautiful, powerful, masculine grandchild, Mazel Tov.
That was the godfather right up until the Jewish part.
His partner, easily the best producer in the game, and I say that from the front of the pack, Chris Stanley.
Is that me?
Thanks for coming to this shit show, Chris. You could have been doing something more productive, like watching a homeless person sleep on the sidewalk. Put your hands together for Ron Bennington and Chris Stanley.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
He's good.
I mean, that seems correct.
He's fucking good.
Complimentary.
And our home team. You listen to these two N-word lovers
Jacob,
Monday through
fuck?
Thursday because Comedy Central doesn't have the sack to cut them loose. From Comedy Central Radio's second most popular show out of two shows, Big Head Todd and the Monster, Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah.
Hop along autism.
Right. Really striking out the ones he loves, I think.
Hey, Jay.
Yeah, buddy.
Your girl stays jocking me. What's up with that?
I mean, you guys work together.
Dan. Would you be mad if you found out I was sexting with Trish?
My mom?
That girl is good to go. Sorry I can't be there for her 70th birthday party. But tell her I was happy to come for her 69th.
Fuck that, dude. Fuck that. I'll take Jacob doing the pussy eating sign on my face any day.
Damn. Even Lou's taking notes.
That's the smoothest brother we know.
Okay, let's get to this fever dream. So you know the game. We have two teams, Jay and Dan versus
good
Chris.
Host.
It looks like
and
somebody's
Ron.
Improv-ing.
We have a set of questions. Questions for Jay and Chris about Ron and Dan. Jay and Chris are going to write on a board. And they're going to compare their answers to the vocal answers of Ron and Dan.
This is not fucking true at all. This isn't how you play the game.
This is the bonfire way.
Whoa!
Oh. Ron, listen,
to
I'm
the
sorry.
Great Ron Bennington.
I think you've helped create a monster. Don't. No!
Oh.
No, Ron, we can find a way to make this work.
No,
guys, come on.
I say that
come
in all
on,
respect.
Come on, Ron. We want to put the tag team titles on the line.
It sounds like we're all on the same team.
No. Me and you sit on this couch, but are opponents.
And then me and Chris will write our answers, and then you guys will say the answer. And we
oh,
see
okay,
we
I got it now.
I
just want to apologize for that walkout. I'm a fucking hothead. I understand that now.
Fucking.
I'm a nervous wreck over this grandbaby thing.
Ron, you have to apologize for nothing. And now, question one.
Who wrote that?
He goes deep. He's a genius. He's
all
an
right.
evil genius.
Question number one.
Yes.
For Jay and Chris, what song best describes your partner in the bedroom?
Oh, shit. That's fucking... That's a difficult one, okay? How long do we have to write? Not very long, I guess, right?
Just a few seconds.
And it can be any song?
By the way, is that Mark Norman hitting on a piece of wood back there?
He does all the sound effects.
He's amazing.
Yeah, he's real good. Costs a lot to hire for a show. One duster.
Time is up.
Oh, it is?
Wow. It was fast.
Now, Ron and I guess?
Yes.
I guess what song describes me best in the bedroom?
Yes.
How about Genuine's Pony?
Fuck. That was way more soulful than I played it. I said, Build Me Up Buttercup.
Oh! That is more Vanilla Dan. Damn it, I gotta stay on brand.
Jacob, could you read this one more time? I'm kind of lost.
What song best describes your partner in the bedroom?
All right.
So what song describes you?
Okay. What song describes me? You know, it's a very difficult thing because I don't know if it could be one song, but if anybody knows me, it's any song by a group out of Sweden called ABBA.
Yeah.
ABBA.
Yeah!
I'm genuinely, that one was impressive.
Wow.
I'm sitting 2 feet away. That's impressive.
And I also would have gotten Build Me Up Buttercup. I just didn't have
for the
chance.
For the steal.
For the steal.
For the steal.
You Quibos enjoying this game? Then make some noise, you fart sniffers. Act like you've been there. Question number two. Fill in the blanks. My partner may be the world's best blank, but also the world's worst blank.
And we're saying this we're about Dan, right? Okay.
And about Ron.
Yes. Oh, and about me as well.
You gotta get on the board on this one. I'm fucking nervous. That ABBA shit was, I saw him turn and I was like, did they talk about that before?
Well, we know each other.
All right, Ron. Quit furthering the divide between Jay and I.
Who, that ill-begotten son of a bitch?
It's true.
You
know I don't like that.
I'm right
I don't
here.
Speak of that ninny.
Time is up.
Oh, jeez.
And now, your answers, please. Dan.
I'm the world's best at voices, but the world's worst singer.
Ooh.
World's best voice guy, world's worst deep kisser. Deep kisser. But it's only my experience. Yeah. It's only my experience with him.
Guys,
it's only my experience.
Guys, his beard hair is itchy, so back up. It's hard to spelunk in that mouth with all that hair scratched.
It's fair. It's fair. I like a beard.
Well, go ahead, Ron. Get it right.
Well, I'm trying to figure out the wordplay on this because where I think you're heading with this is kind of using the same word, right? So I'm gonna go with a rock and roll band, or really a pop band, as well as a bug. And I'm gonna say the world's best Beatles and the world's worst Beatle.
Beatles.
Beatles!
Beatles.
Chris Stanley, ladies and gentlemen!
You guys like it?
I can smell a fix.
What?
I can smell a fix.
What's that
supposed
to
mean? This is how fucking Wild Bill Hickok got killed in Deadwood. You're treating me, Bennington.
What are you talking about?
Nah, it was too. You fucking walked too far for that explanation.
Chicken for a fucking earpiece. Is he wearing an earpiece?
Wow. Is this a quiz show?
Is he impractical joking us?
Sal Volcano, show your face.
Great job, Ron and Chris.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You wouldn't happen to have any job opening coming up, would you?
For a whippersnapper like you, a hot young kid on his way to the top? Yeah, we can look into that.
What a slap to the face, Jacob.
Question number three.
You want to just give it to us?
Which one of your partner's friends do you find most attractive?
Oh. Which one of your partner's friends?
Which one?
I'm going to say which one of your friends do I find the most attractive.
All right, and let them go first.
Wait, which one of my friends do you want to fuck? Is it Fartbox or Beret?
Fartbox.
I heard.
You know what? You're not wrong, Ron.
I heard Beret on the phone today. Go ahead.
Your answers.
All right.
Do you?
You go.
Dave Smith. Who said Jesus Christ? Dave Smith's a great looking guy.
He's a great looking guy, but come on. Total package? Justin Silver, man, the Beastmaster. Come on, the guy's built like a brick shit house. We suck.
It's gonna be a long car ride to Comedy Connection with Justin.
Why don't you think I'm the most attractive friend?
So, like, what is it? Because Dave's tall or something?
You do good voice stuff. That's amazing. All right, whose friend is it? My friend or his friend?
I'm getting a little confused myself.
Yes.
You're in charge.
You just pick one.
His friend.
Oh, his friend, then it's Coldplay.
Coldplay?
Come on. No, he brings her around all the time. She's a chick from Astoria.
Oh, you know what's been Coldplay?
Yeah. Hey, what's the score now?
It's 3-0.
3-0.
I mean, Chris, I know you pretty well. Where's this Coldplay character I never seem to have met?
When we ever hang out outside the radio station?
A couple times.
Coldplay's not coming around.
All right.
She's a half a prostitute from Astoria, Queens.
Just fair. Half.
The bottom half.
Exactly
yeah,
right.
Go anywhere. Yeah. The world.
It's exactly yeah. right. No one fucks her mouth.
Hey, Melonhead. You think you can do an impression of a guy who knows what he's doing?
Jesus fucking Christ.
Wow.
Where the fuck is this coming from, Jacob? If you say your notes, I'm going to fucking give you a lariat.
That'd be unbelievable. In honor of the great Stan Hansen. Fucking lariat.
Yeah, loaded lariat. It's yeah. Jay's finishing move. I'm more of a Cobra Clutch guy.
The perfect partner is one who blank.
What?
This might be our chance, Jay. We can steal this question.
The perfect partner is the one who blank.
How many questions is there altogether?
Take 10.
10?
We'll probably get to 6.
This is 4.
We're not gonna
We're tearing
lie.
Through.
This was a stoned hotel room conversation.
I feel good. I feel good. This is a good one. Okay. Dan?
All right, I think the perfect partner will let you F their T's.
I wrote the perfect partner believes in the other one, but...
Don't know each other.
I got sappy with it, I'm sorry. I got hung up. We're traveling together. I got very happy to be in a romantic city with you.
Your answers.
Well, are we I know this for a fact about... Our own Chris Stanley, he is what I call a backdoor man, all right? The men don't know, but the little girls, they understand. And by the way, he eat more chicken than any man ever seen. So I'm going to simply say, doors.
Doors.
It seems like we've lost the crowd here somehow.
Aren't you impressed?
You're cheating scoundrels.
What do you guys have, money on this game?
Maybe some of them do with me, maybe not.
Oh, right, Melonhead.
It's not wrong.
Right, you put snugglers enjoying this? We're gonna be switching the boards now. Questions for Ron and Dan about Jay and Chris.
What's the score now?
4-0, Ron.
Jesus Christ.
No, beat down.
Stupid. If your partner could show...
We're actually walking the room here. This is getting sad.
It's a massacre. I'd leave the game, too, if it was 5-0.
If I was watching a team cheat their way to victory...
How would we be fucking cheating?
I don't know,
We
Ron.
Know each other.
I don't know your system, but it's pissing me off.
No system.
I'll friendship? Tell you what,
you're about to watch a full-grown man sulk in a duster.
That's not the personality to have with that.
This is not the jacket for sulking.
You're going to sit Indian style in a duster and drink a glass of milk?
I would love to.
Ron, Chris, I see the way you work together, and my word, Vito really doesn't know how good he has it, does he?
No. That's true.
No.
That one hurt the most.
Next question.
God, you're a robot.
It must be true that opposites attract because my partner and I are total opposites when it comes to blank.
Oh.
Fuck. Got it.
Do you?
Did you write already?
No. I'm so lost.
What's opposites about us?
I don't even know anymore. Jay, I'm freaking out. The girl in the corner just goes, oh. What are we opposite about?
Why don't we start with Ron?
Yeah. Why don't we, Jacob?
You know, Chris, this is a rough day for him, you know, because you lost that fucking DJ that you loved all these years.
Yeah, Avicii.
Avicii. And that's
love
why
that guy.
Yeah, he's unbelievable. But I'm more of a classic rock guy. So I'm gonna simply just say Foghat.
It's Foghat.
Wait, what? I don't think you said Foghat before you revealed it.
They just did it the wrong direction.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Dan, what did you write?
Hi, I'm Dan Soder. And I'm a sheriff. I'm a sheriff now.
Dan, what did you write down?
What did I write down? I wrote down 76ers.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's what I was going to say, 76ers. Points.
I feel like we're being cheated right now.
This is bullshit.
I feel these two midway marks have figured out how to play the fucking game.
Ron Bennington, I don't like the way you're using your words.
You're coming at Dan all wrong on Duster Day.
Duster Dan, don't fuck around.
As a judge, I'm going to award that to Ron and Chris.
Jesus!
Oh!
Christ!
They can't do this!
Right or wrong, Jay.
What's the slaughter rule on this?
Right or wrong, Jay? I just hate watching words come out of your face. The way they tumble out makes me want to kick a baby.
Wow. I don't know if I like heel Jacob.
And our final question.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, shit.
All right, I'm going to start writing it down.
Whom would play your partner?
I got my answer.
Whom would play your partner in a movie?
Ooh. I'm saying who would play you, just so you know.
Oh, fuck.
You're going to do who would play me?
Yeah.
Are you do who would play me? And then
all right, yeah.
Hey, don't you guys want to figure out who you're going to say who's going to play who?
No.
All right,
we're fine. Yeah.
Who's going to play me, Dan?
Don't worry about us.
We've worked together for 11 years. I mean,
you want to say it?
I was going to say 49ers? I don't know. I'm just trying to find something you're going to write. Who's going to play me? Shit. The guy from Lost. That always hurts.
No. Come on, man. Come on. No, 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 no.
Oliver Platt. That still stings a bunch.
You got any sugar?
Vincent D'Onofrio?
Vincent D'Onofrio, 49ers. So we got 2 points. Justice is served.
Obviously, Genesis would play Ron in the movie.
The entire band Genesis, or the book of Genesis.
And let's just make this straight. It's the Peter Gabriel fucking Genesis.
That's what I meant.
The original.
Okay. Well, I don't care what the score says. Bennington Show wins.
Boom.
Team Bennington for life. Yeah. Bennington! 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 Bennington!
Bennington!
Weekdays, noon to 3.
Bennington.
Before you go to break, may I read a statement?
Please, please.
Jay,
mm-hmm.
Dan.
Yes. Yeah.
What's one of the biggest turn-ons when you sleep, when you're with a girl?
That she's
alive.
I'll
tell you, no. If you want to have sex with somebody who's passed. Let's say you were in a slump.
Yeah.
Now you feel like, I got this, because you can be the worst lay of all time.
So you went on a date.
In Florida,
with a lady you met.
Bumble date.
Bring Jacob to another beach that isn't in Florida.
I mean, Jacob goes back to Florida a lot. You think he's killing chicks in Florida, and then his thing is like, I don't live in Florida.
Manhunt for a serial killer in Tampa. 3 people were killed in the same neighborhood.
You think he's dextering women with these knives?
And he went, when I went, twice in the face. I jabbed him.
Can I tell you something? It's not just me. When I said it, everybody in the room thought in your head it could be a possibility.
If you were super into business cards, I'd be really worried about you.
You are. You're just talking about the morning of Dexter and American Psycho.
Yeah.
By the way,
this was like a splinter in my mind.
It makes taking eggs. Tie my shoelaces. After I make sure they're the same length, then I tie them. Then I tie them slowly. It's all intricate.
You know what he does? Yeah. He goes with Colorado to shoot guns.
He's very quiet. He'll light your shit up.
You feel ready.
He goes to Florida to make knives. He goes to Florida a lot, and now he's making knives down there.
You gotta
be
prepared.
You want to really get something? I got knives covered.
Staying at his mother's house making knives, dude. This is the Norman Bates story.
Like, he took me into the woods.
His other activity he does down there, and everyone's gonna back this up when I say this. Scuba diving.
I'm gonna stop when I'm dead.
What better place to hide your dismembered bodies, like Dexter, in the waters of Florida?
I love her backsplashes. When she does the kitchens.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I want to have a guy moment, like, can't we just talk? Or you think so, Doctor?
When you sever the head, they say the brain function lasts for about another 54 seconds.
You like Huey Lewis in the news?
Because then, when a woman dies, she doesn't know she's going to die. It's just a little too late.